guys. Guys, Dustin, clear the table. So, Rodney, do you want to introduce us to the game?
Yeah, yeah, that sounds good. So this is Dusk City Outlaws. This is my first solo game. I created it. It is a game where we are going to pull off a job as a crew of thieves in a huge fantasy city. Think like Renaissance Venice, but on the scale of modern-day New York. Vast fantasy city where you guys are going to be a gang of thieves who are going to get a job from a broker, and you're going to have to plan and then execute that job. I'm going to go around and let you all introduce yourselves so that everybody knows who the players are here today. So, Eric, you already kind of introduced yourself. I'll let you hit it again.
I'm just Eric Benson. I help run the Divvy to Loot streaming channel with my partner, Greg Bilsland. And that's all I'm going to – I'd rather focus on everybody else playing.
Good. I'm Kate Welch. I'm a video game UI designer at Amazon Game Studios, and I worked on a game called Guild Wars 2 for a long time.
I heard of that. I am Liz Smith, also known as Dammit Liz. You can find me on Twitter at Dammit _ Liz, because Dammit Liz was taken by somebody who never used it. I'm over it. anyway, I am actually freelancing right now because I am in between opportunities, so I can do awesome things like this. Which I'm very excited about.
Without having to check with any department.
I know. Yeah, hashtag tweet whatever the fuck I want.
Sorry,
oh,
Amazon,
can we swear?
We just made this a blue broadcast.
This is a blue.
You're welcome, internet.
if the alcohol wasn't enough,
right. I mean, you guys are a band of thieves, yeah, so that seems legit.
Mine's apple juice. I don't know.
What's your Twitter handle? Because I want people to find you because you're amazing.
My Twitter handle is at SheGeekShow. SheGeekShow. Okay. Follow me if you dare.
Sweet, can I go?
Yes. Your turn.
Hey, I'm Wayne Daughtry. I'm president and CTO at Ticker House Games.
That's awesome. We haven't caught up in so long. Okay, sorry. Go ahead.
I didn't know. Really? Get out.
Don't say.
I've actually been playing versions of this in development for a while. I'm really excited about where the game's gotten to. I'm really excited it's on Kickstarter. I'm Gamer Laner on Twitch, and I can't wait to get started playing.
Cool.
And as I understand it, we all are supposed to call Rodney Rodman, and that's like
Dennis Rodman.
Do not do that thing.
The Rodman.
On the stream and in most social media. That's how
if you ever meet him in real life, be like Rodman, he'll know you're in the cool club.
He told us we couldn't be on the stream unless we called him that. It's ridiculous.
None of these things are true.
True. It's actually, there was an email yesterday that came out. Not, and we're like,
I feel safe personally.
Oh,
not
I mean
accurate.
On the wrong line.
Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get started here. So Dusk City Outlaws is a tabletop role-playing game, but it's designed to be pulled off the shelf and played without a lot of prep time. The idea is that, like, it's game night and you want to play an RPG, but nobody's done any prep work. Well, Dusk City Outlaws is the kind of game you can play. So I'm going to actually walk through as though we didn't have any prep in advance, which none of these people actually did. So like I said, you guys are going to be a band of thieves, and we're going to go ahead and make your characters. And the way you make your characters is you're going to pick one card from each of these two stacks. Now, one stack, the ones over there closest to Liz and Lane, those are the cartels. These are big, colorful organizations that rule over the criminal underworld of New Dunhaven. They all sort of have their own methods and goals and themes. And so one of those, one of the parts of your character is going to be one of those. The other part is going to be over here. These are your specialties. Specialty is what you do on the job. It's like assassin or brawler or boss or, you know, thief or grifter. These are all sort of roles on the job, things that you're really good at. Each is going to come with some special abilities that, when combined together, give you everything that you need to play your character. So I'm going to give you a moment to go ahead and look through those. As you guys are looking through them and picking the ones that you want, just pull them out and set them in front of you, and then that'll be everything you need to do to make your character to get started, except for things like giving yourself a name. So and since the audience at home can't actually see these, feel free to narrate a little bit about what you're thinking as you look through them.
I'm looking at these. These are the roles.
Specialties.
These are awesome. There's one that's called a grifter. There's a cleaner. You make problems go away. You've got poisoner. You've got mastermind. You've got mole, which I read as mole. Now I'm kind of hungry. But mole.
Yeah, that specialty is delicious, actually.
Yeah, that sounds awesome. There's a brawler. There's an alchemist. A basher. Oh, you break stuff. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to wreck it. You're the boss. What's the difference between the boss and the mastermind?
The boss is sort of like the boots on the ground leader, like really good at coordinating people.
Ooh,
the mastermind is
an
more
event
about.
Producer?
The mastermind is more about the overall plan.
I see.
I stole Assassin because I thought that was interesting, the hitman.
I'm going to take the cleaner.
Oh, okay.
So fascinating.
Stunning.
I'm going to be a grifter.
If this affects your decisions, let me go ahead and tell you a little bit. This job is going to be breaking a prisoner out of a district jail before they can be transferred to the castle.
Interesting.
The castle is like a big fortress-like prison that overlooks the water.
Okay.
Sounds like a job for the Red Lotus Society mastermind.
Okay.
Rodman Rothman.
No, don't do
that. Is
that
your name?
Yeah. Oh. Rodman Rothman. I have heard of you.
So
you have done many a heist.
You want mastermind?
I would like mastermind.
Okay.
I'm going to say lockpicking is going to be important.
Huge? Yeah. Could
I'm going to be an assassin so I can murder people. I mean, get people out of the way.
Oh,
now,
wait.
Is an assassin one of the classes that can be unlocked on the Kickstarter?
No, no. These are all.
These are all
sorry. This is the complete prototype. That's everything that's going to be in the final game. What's available right now when you back the Kickstarter is the Quick Start. And yes, the Assassin is part of the Quick Start rules. So if you want to see what the Assassin is, you can actually see what that is online right now.
So tell me what the advantages and disadvantages are of these
cards. Sure. I'll run through them real quick.
Yeah, yeah.
So the Circle, which is the one that Liz has in her hand right there, they are big, tough brawlers. They're often the muscle on the job.
Look at this muscle. There's so many muscles.
She is muscly. The Family, they are the wealthiest cartel. They have the most influence. They're the oldest cartel. They sort of operate in the merchant parts of the city. The Forgotten are a cartel of criminals that are they mostly sort of fallen through the cracks of society. Lots of street gangs, beggars, basically people that don't have a place in sort of law-abiding society. The Gravediggers, they control the city's graveyards, mortuaries, cemeteries, funeral parlors, etc. They basically ply their criminal trade by being so creepy that people don't actually want to deal with them. Right?
Yeah, can I have a Gravedigger
like
card?
In life.
They basically do unsavory things to get people to ignore them.
So you have two of each card. Does that mean at least two people can do?
Yes.
Be in
so
the
there's
same
there's two of each cartel card, which means that you are limited by the physical components. So you can never have more than two of any one cartel in a single. In a single job.
Cool.
So the Mummers, they are a cartel of entertainers. They're actors and musicians and bards, and they basically hold the other cartels together. They are really good at dealing with other criminals. The Red Lotus Society, they are a cartel that controls illegal firearms. They have gunpowder. They have access to flintlock weapons. They also have the only naval presence of all of the cartels. The Vespers, they deal in high society crime. They target the nobility with schemes and cons and basically ply their trade in the upper echelons of polite society. And then the Wardens of the Night is the final one. The Wardens of the Night are, they are kind of revolutionaries and rebels. They believe that the city's government is tyrannical and they are all outlaws. Sort of Robin Hood-esque in a lot of ways, right? They operate in the sort of wilderness reserves of the city and then come out at night in the city. They're kind of like urban rangers by and large. So that's the
ignore the phrase night ranger.
There are sort of night rangers.
I'm not a
yeah.
Oh, man, so no, being I a, be being an effective ranger. Thief, mm-hmm. all of these cartels have appearances that allow you to understand where you and when you are conspicuous according to your appearance.
Yeah. So being conspicuous means that if you're out in that part of the city, other people are going to notice that you're there, and it's going to generate heat, which is a resource that I will spend to introduce complications.
Glorious.
Yeah. So.
So everywhere, being a thief, that's like an effective one, is probably like you don't want to take a class like the Mummers.
You can. Like, again, it's all about the flavor of the character, right? Like, the mechanics are pretty broad and wide open. And so, for example, you even have an ability that lets you get into any building on the second story just whenever you, like, however you want to. So your specialty can kind of cover up for any deficiencies that your cartel might provide. And then your cartel, by and large, will also give you the ability to operate in different parts of society. So you absolutely could be, like, a Vesper thief. And that just, that might mean something different to you than if you're a Mummer thief or a Red Lotus thief.
So from a game design perspective, what I'm feeling like is taking my specialty is my primary role, and then taking my cartel is sort of like a supplement flavor to it.
That is one way to look at it, yeah.
Okay.
The other way you might look at it is that your cartel defines your role in the world, like it's your big, colorful organization that you're a part of, and then these are the specific skills that you, as a member of that cartel, bring to the job. That's another way to look at
it. Got it, okay.
Super cool.
What district is this prison that we're
like? Don't know yet. I've given you a little bit of a hint. But part of the fun is taking the skills that you have and the nature of your character and figuring out a plan that works for that combination.
Guys, just so you know, I can create one dose of poison that I can describe to the judge before we go on
ice.
Nice. This is great.
You can also...
This has been your
we can use a hearse.
So
guys,
many
we can use a hearse. We're just like
played.
The Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
Okay, so I see here I have assassin, and I'm sort of skipping ahead. It says, yeah. Carve your way out. So I have advantage of... I get two advantage dice on any attacks mm-hmm. made against minions. And then if I take the forgotten, I add two advantage dice to any roll... Oh, with commoners, so it would be different.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that the one like, that you get from your cartel is often socially oriented.
Okay.
With a few
oh,
exceptions.
Cool.
All right.
Yeah,
so,
right?
You, so
right?
It feels like you've already built your character over here. So we have a Gravedigger Poisoner.
Yes.
Okay,
and
cool.
I absolutely love everything about this right now.
So Lane, you wanted the mastermind, right?
I would like the mastermind.
All right.
Please.
And you are a Red Lotus mastermind.
I'm a Red Lotus mastermind, disgraced former navalman.
The gambling hall. Okay.
Who needs to move his mic a little
or
closer?
Or a house of pleasure.
That sounds very real. House of pleasure? Is that what you just said?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm listening.
That's how we roll.
Okay. I'm
Go
gonna
on.
I'm going to try kind of a weird... I'm going to take a weird combo. I'm going to try a Vesper thief.
That seems good.
I don't think there's anything weird about that. Most Vespers
Thanks,
are
Eric.
Traditionally thieves. Right?
You're Thomas.
Yeah. Yeah,
you're
so.
Thomas Crown, but Lady Thomas Crown.
There
yeah,
you go.
Lady Thomas Crown.
All right.
Sounds delightful to me.
So, Liz, you've got your special. You're
okay, I'm an
your
assassin.
Cartel. Okay, cool.
I think I'm going to go with the Forgotten.
Okay.
I'm a Forgotten Assassin.
Okay, great. So why don't you go ahead and take all the other unused specialties and cartels, and we'll stack those up and get them out of the way. In the meantime, you need to come up with a name for your character. Now, if you look on the back of your cartel sheet, you'll see at the bottom there's a list of suggested
nice.
Character names. So
Lenora.
If you can't come up with anything just on your own.
Minerva.
Good place to start.
Oh,
Excellent.
I got nicknames.
Oh,
one of
yes.
the nicknames here is Ugly.
Yes.
Three Fingers.
Oh, this is great.
Oh, my God.
You're saying we could refer to you as Ugly Three Fingers for the rest of the game?
I don't know.
Ugly Three Fingers.
Light Finger. So Light Finger Three Fingers. They are only three, but they are all very light.
Well, numerically speaking, alone, there's less of them.
Oh, right. So
yeah.
I'm light on fingers.
One of the last names of mine is LaCroix, which is one of my favorite carbonated beverages.
Oh, that's good.
So I think I'm going to go with like Grapefruit LaCroix for my
Grapefruit
name.
LaCroix.
Yeah.
Fast Betty. Is an option here.
Could you please be fast, Betty?
Sorry, Pamplemousse LaCroix, since it's...
There you go.
Right,
it's
French.
Fancy. Yeah, Pamplemousse.
So go ahead and you write your name on there. You can also write down your specialty and your cartel on the sheet. The only other things that you need to know are that you start with 100 luck, which everybody always starts with 100 luck.
Story of my life.
And you're also all going to start with one influence, which I will pass out. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Take one and pass it down.
Oh, these are great.
Holy crap. Do these come with the game?
You can get these as a part of the Kickstarter campaign. They are metal coins that are being produced by campaign coins. So these are the influence coins. You can get these as an add-on or as a part of,
you get one of them.
The deluxe edition of the game. Yeah.
I don't know how this interaction is working.
Guys,
I'm confused.
This is really cool to see these coins come into fruition because as Lane and I were playtesting the game, we've been using poker chips. And
yeah.
Now
it's a lot nicer.
To see these coins actually and feel the weight of them is really, really cool. And
also
I'm so excited for
this. Also going to put one of these out there if you put it out in the middle. This is a crew influence. This can be spent by anyone.
So that's a party resource.
Yep, party resource.
Okay.
So there's one for the entire crew, and then you each have one individual one.
The project manager.
I will just take care of it.
Wait,
democracy?
Did you go with,
or can we just snatch it?
You are working together.
Okay.
Ass
in. Sorry.
Okay.
The forgotten.
Together for now.
So I'm just ass in, and you don't
until
remember.
Until falls apart.
Until we betray all house and all this shit.
Who's the traitor? Who's working for the cops?
Okay. Explain the. So what's your deal? Line?
So what's your deal is just a section where if you want to write down any character details, you can put them there. Right. So like if you've got a combination of cartel and specialty. Right. So whatever that means to you, you can feel free to write anything there. You don't have to put anything there if you don't want to. But it's just basically like, okay, here's my character's shtick.
I'm going to write, I don't know, what's your deal?
That's a great response,
yeah,
actually.
That's good. That's a good character.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so as you guys are putting the last touches on your character here, I'm going to briefly explain the way the game is going to work. You guys are going to get the job from a broker, which we'll do that very next thing. Then we're going to go into a series of day and nighttime segments. And then as the day and night segments pass, you guys are going to come up with a plan. You're going to then get out in the city to do legwork to put that plan in place. And then eventually you're going to have to pull off that plan. And that's basically it. But a lot of it's going to be up on you guys to come up with the plan. All right, so we've got our advantage and challenge dice out there where everybody can reach them. We've got character names incoming. Everybody's got a deal.
Do we talk about, are we going to introduce our characters?
Yes, okay. Absolutely. Okay, so we should be getting pretty close here. Everybody's got a character name. Everybody's got a shtick. All right, so the first thing that we're going to do is let you guys introduce your character. So give us a your name, your cartel and your specialty, and a brief description of either what your character looks like or maybe what your character's doing at the time when the broker's agents come to you to retrieve you and take you on the job. So think about, like, at the beginning of The Usual Suspects when they round up all the different crew. What is your scene in that moment? And because you're sitting immediately to my left, Eric, I'm going to make you go first.
Sure. I am playing today Sebastian Wormwood, who is a gravedigger, and the gravediggers control the city's mortuaries, crematoriums, the hearses, the cemeteries, the catacombs, and the mausoleums. But he's also a poisoner. Now, as a poisoner,
that's a role.
Yeah, okay. that's my specialty.
I thought that was just like a thing he does. One of his hobbies.
Yeah, he just concocts deadly poisons, but I do know how to handle deadly ingredients
and
combine them
pork constantly
into poisons. But Sebastian, he took a little different route. He's the proprietor of the Rigors of Mortis, his bar where he concocts his poisons. So if people need to find themselves under the ground, they get sent to his bar, and somehow something.
Would it be fair to call you a necromixologist?
I would highly like this.
So basically, criminals send people they want bumped off to the Rigors of Mortis.
Yes.
And you poison them?
And I poison them.
So
I slip something right in their cocktail.
Perfect.
And just kind of
like uncooked pork.
Yes.
All right.
Knock them off.
So good.
Awesome. All right, Kate?
My character is named Pamplemousse LaCroix. She is a very well-educated, very aristocratic member of society. She's one of the Vespers. They're sneaky. Their specialty is blackmail, and they can worm their way into any kind of high society function that they want to. Now, Pamplemousse is she's a little bit unusual because she's also an incredible thief. And she's walking around in these high fashions. She's very visible. She doesn't give two shits. She's gonna pick your pocket, and there's nothing you can say about it, because why would someone such
You're playing
amazing
you.
I'm playing Winona Ryder when she went on her kleptomania phase.
Oh, anyway. Yeah, nice.
No, but one of the things that Pamplemousse LaCroix is known for is throwing enormous high society parties. She can get the hottest chefs, the best bartenders, the best venues at a moment's notice because of her family name, and then robbing everyone blind and blaming it on literally anything else that she can. So that's her. She doesn't need the money, but she does it for the thrill.
Nice.
Nice.
Awesome.
Right, I am playing Fast Betty Twerkin.
What?
She is...
So if you leave out your middle name, you're just Fast Twerkin?
Yeah. Well, Fast is my middle name. So if I leave
out
first name. Yeah. That's my nickname. Sorry.
Okay.
It's my nickname. She is an assassin. So she likes to murder people and get obstacles out of the way. She's also a member of the Forgotten Cartel, so like the street gangs and that sort of thing. She joined up with them because her parents were killed by nobles, and she has serious issues with nobles because her parents were killed.
You're not actually a noble. You just rob nobles. So you're okay. You guys can be friends.
She is very good at stabbing things and loves to stab.
Of course.
And no one knows what she looks like, not even herself.
She doesn't appear in mirrors?
She always is wearing a mask.
I'm going to red flag that right
always
now.
Wearing a mask,
if you're not appearing
awesome
in mirrors, that's okay. A real problem.
but amazing
I'm okay
to
with
be an
it.
Assassin.
I'm good with the grave stuff.
Yeah,
I'm good with that.
All right, she's always wearing a mask, and so she doesn't even know now what she looks like.
That's I can't wait to introduce you as my associate, Miss Twerkin. Somewhere in the midst of this. Yeah. I was not kidding about my name earlier. I'm a Red Lotus Society mastermind.
Wait, sorry, what's your name again?
Rodman Rothman.
Good.
Yes.
And his story is actually he was part of the city's navy and was a privateer hunter, and actually due to corruption and vice was court-martialed and now is disgraced. So he's been taken under the wing of the Red Lotus Society because they have people to or need people to ply their ships.
Aww.
I know.
Does he wear a bathrobe a lot?
He does. I'm dressed up like him specifically. He actually spends his time in seedy gambling halls, in heavy drink, trying to win money at games of chance.
Yeah, I've noticed you around the bar every now and then.
I come around, well, when you are having people there after the races and whatnot.
Naturally.
Rigor and Mortis is the name of your bar?
The Rigors of Mortis.
The Rigors of Mortis.
Oh, I like Rigor and Mortis.
Our next
well,
door.
That's the satellite bar.
Can those be your pet rats?
That's a speakeasy downstairs.
They've been easy. No, pet ferrets.
Rigor and Mortis. Yes,
the character building.
You've got a fixation. Expansion.
I actually, I'm
up on my mind.
I don't actually. I'm a little bit uncomfortable being out actually on the job.
Yeah,
I
we're
do
a little
it when
uncomfortable
I need to.
Because
at this
too,
point, so. I've kind of turned into a recluse, aside from being at the bars, alcoholic. But I do have a mind for looking forward and seeing how things are going to shake out.
Okay.
Will you pass me the Kilkerin, please, Rodman Rothman?
Indeed.
Thank you.
All right, so.
I'll take that later.
So, Pamplemousse, Fast Betty, and Rodman. The three of you are trundling down the city streets inside a hearse. Now, this hearse is basically a big coach that has big, thick blackout curtains hanging down the inside so
You're
no
welcome.
One can see in or out. And this hearse is pulled by a team of four black horses, and there's a dour coachman driving the thing. And you basically are... you've been picked up by agents of the broker and are rumbling down the road. And it's a pretty rough ride across the cobblestones. You can't see where you're going. It smells musty in here. There's a faint smell of decay. But eventually the...
Is there a body?
There's not a body,
okay.
No.
Seems they don't feel suspension is important once you're dead.
Oh, no. No. No need for suspension. But eventually the hearse rattles up to...
Am I smelling salt?
Yes. rattles to a stop, and the footman opens the door for you. The curtains are pulled back, and you see that you're outside a building that is clearly a mortuary. In fact, the sign that shows you, or the sign out in front, identifies it as the Long Shadow Mortuary. It's an old manor house, obviously. It looks like it once belonged to a noble, but when the nobility moved out of this district of the city, it was left behind and then reclaimed by the gravediggers as a mortuary and funeral parlor. So you are led up to the front door, and when you get up to the front, you can actually see that, you know, these mortuaries and these funeral parlors that the gravediggers have, they're legitimate businesses. So it has a nice sign. It has the operating hours. But you notice as you come in that the archway over the front door, there's tiny little scratches in the plaster above that you all recognize as thief signs. And you can read it very easily.
Yes.
It basically says, friendly to the right kind of people, inquire within daytime or nighttime sanctuary of the grave diggers. And so you go inside, and inside the mortuary is dusty. Everything's kind of smells of decay. There are flickering candles that illuminate the inside of the building, but they all give off a sickly green light instead of the normal yellow light. So everything is sort of bathed in green light as you're led down the hallway in the front of this mortuary. And like there's wallpaper on the walls that's peeling off gently. And you just kind of get the feeling this place has been either long abandoned or just left to kind of rot on the inside.
Cozy. I feel right at home.
So the three of you...
Not that bad.
You're led by the coach driver down the hallway, and eventually you come upon a large black oak door. And the coach driver kind of looks at you all suspiciously. He leans up to the door, and he gives a knock. And you can tell that it has a rhythm of like a secret knock to let people know that someone is coming in. The door opens, and you see on the other side two people. One of them is, in fact, your companion Sebastian Wormwood here, who will be joining your crew shortly. But Sebastian is standing behind a wooden desk, and sitting in a chair next to him, behind the desk, is a man who soon identifies himself as Cyrus Umbervale. Now, Cyrus is a tall, thin man who looks more like a walking corpse than anything else. And he's got sort of sunken cheeks, his skin's a little droopy and gray, and he has a sallow complexion. And he invites you all, and he says, "Please come in. Have a seat. Take your ease." And he gestures to these three armchairs that are kind of moldering, and like the stuffing is popping out of one armrest, and like one of the legs looks like it's been half eaten away by rats. But he gestures towards them and says, "I'll have someone bring drinks in just a moment." And he turns a gesture towards your coachman, who's just sort of like standing there sagging, looking at the ground. He goes, "Ugh." And he shuffles off.
I will sit in one of those seats while throwing my robe over another one for our friend the Vesper here. Aww. To sit upon. And she clearly looks uncomfortable.
Bathrobes are better, I'm sure.
Thank you.
But he turns it inside out, at least, so you know. So once you're all seated, Cyrus...
I don't sit.
Okay, once the two of you are seated, Cyrus gets the point quickly. He says, "One of our best cleaners, a man by the name of Alvinius Grimes, has recently gone missing." He gestures towards Sebastian here, and Sebastian... you've been given like a scroll that has a drawing of Alvinius Grimes on it. So you just go,
and I'm also like twirling a bottle of poison in my other hand.
Okay.
Right, like just going through my fingers.
I hope it's
I'm
an ingested,
in
not
bottle.
An inhaled poison. Okay. And he says, "Grimes unfortunately has an important task to do for us, and his vanishing has been something of an inconvenience, but fortunately we've learned that he has been detained in the 14th Royal Precinct House in High Road County. Unfortunately, due to the urgency of other matters, I cannot spare a team of gravediggers to free him from the precinct house, but young Sebastian here has kindly offered to assist in putting together a crew to liberate Mr. Grimes from his untimely detainment. The job I have for you is simple. By
oh, I'm so glad you said that.
By dawn of the day after tomorrow, you must retrieve him from the precinct house. At that point, a coach, armored and protected, will arrive from the castle to cart him away. And oh, we can't have that. So please.
I can have it done in an hour.
Why
hired her?
He smiles and he says, "I hope."
I look surprised at that.
"I hope that your skills are as refined as your sense of boasting." He says, "Master Grimes will, Master Sebastian will provide you with any further details that we have, but unfortunately, those are few and far between." All right, so he's giving you the job, and now the way this is going to work is you guys are going to get a planning scene right away. This is where you guys are going to talk through how you're going to go about pulling this off. You have a limited amount of time to retrieve this man from jail. However, there are some complications. Obviously, jails are well protected, and they are often watched by large numbers of guards. I'm going to go ahead and turn over this timer here. This is a 15-minute timer.
Ooh.
This is the amount of time you guys have for this planning scene. Just to let you know how this is going to work, you guys are going to have a planning scene. You're going to have one scene to get out and do, the daytime of the next day, to get out and do any legwork that you want to do out in the city. Basically go out and put things in motion or, you know, recruit allies or whatever it is you need to do to get ready to pull off your plan. And then nighttime after that, you can then execute your plan because you have to be done by the end of that nighttime. The other way you could do it is you can use this planning that we're about to do, come up with your plan, and then go straight there during the daytime and try and get him out during the day. That's going to be completely up to you, but it's going to be a little bit more difficult. because you won't have had the legwork phase to gather information and put things in motion. So I'm going to go ahead and start this timer. You guys are doing your planning here in the Long Shadow Mortuary. The broker, Cyrus Umbervale, has left. Drinks were left for you, as you can see in front of you.
I did not touch them.
And so I'm going to go ahead and start this timer and turn it over to you guys.
Well, I don't see the problem here. I am a thief. We pick locks. That's what we do. Let's get this guy out.
How are you going
to
get in?
So you just want to go to the
prison? We need to case... No. Okay. We need to case the joint. I don't think you know anything about prisons.
Also a specialty of mine.
Really? You just walk into a prison and are just going to be like, hey, I'm a noble, let me
look
in.
Look at my number two skill, case the joint.
Oh, really? That is also my number three skill, but it's the same percentage, so...
Well, maybe we should work together.
I don't know.
Fast bank.
I think we should work together as a team. Now, what do we know about the region that the jail is in, where he's being held?
All right. 14th precinct.
Indeed. So on your sheet, on your cartel sheet, you'll
keep
all see a section that is things you know about. Do any of you on your cartel sheet?
On my cartel sheet.
Yes.
Things I know about.
Things you know
okay.
about. Yes. Yeah. So, do any of you know about jails and prisons?
I've never seen the inside of one.
Okay. Do any of you know about commoners?
I do. I'm a commoner.
Wonderful. All right. So you know that the 14th Royal Precinct House is in High Road County. It is a commoner's district.
Oh, sweet. That's my district, yo.
Yes. You know that this particular precinct house is in family turf. So that is the turf run by the cartel known as the family.
Okay.
And that is the extent of what you know about it right now. But you do know where it is.
Okay.
So you don't have to, like, hunt through the city for it.
Okay. So I think we should go case the joint, figure out how many guards are at the front, figure out how many guards are going to be inside, and then I can sneak inside like nobody's business and stabby-stab people in the back, and then you can get in there and pick that lock.
We're not animals.
Yeah, I mean, there's other ways to go about this.
Okay.
And I say, you know, I could obtain us a corpse that we could switch his body with this corpse.
That's great. How are we going to get that corpse in?
Ways.
Methods.
Things.
What's your also, thought on this, Captain?
I could just shut the whole single district down for the day if I so choose.
What does that mean? Please, like on. The power grid?
Yeah. I can ask the crown. I've got my ways. Don't ask how, but I can ask the crown to let nobody in or out of that district.
Okay.
Entire day.
Intriguing.
Yes, one of the things that you need to deal with is not only retrieving him from the prison, but you also need to make a clean getaway.
Oh, well, that's different.
Yeah.
I thought this was capture the flag, not bring the flag back.
So the way I approach a problem like this is to gather as much information as possible right off the bat, because I don't know anything about this district or this safe house. Or not safe house, excuse me, this holding cell. In.
The precinct house.
Precinct house. That's there what I'm looking for. Thank you. So I would like to case the joint.
I think that's a good idea.
Let's case the joint.
Case the joint is my specialty, my super specialty.
It is your number one.
So the way that legwork is going to work is each of you is going to take the lead on a legwork scene, but then you can all participate in each other's legwork scene. So basically each of you is going to define one thing that you're going to do. So going to the jail and the precinct house and casing the joint, that is absolutely the kind of thing you want to do with a legwork scene. Mm-hmm. But you can also do other things on top of that. So you're going to have a whole, you're each going to have a scene that you get to define that counts for legwork. If you look on the back of your specialty sheet, you'll see that there is basically a description of how the different phases go.
Getting the job done.
Yes, indeed, getting the job done. In the legwork phase, in the blue box there, you'll see a section that is basically a template for how you're going to define what a legwork scene is. This basically is, you're going to follow this to set up the scene, and then I'll introduce any challenges and complications, and then we'll actually play the scene out. So you guys control what the different scenes are. It's all based on like what you want to accomplish. So casing the joint.
How many legwork scenes do we get?
For this particular job, you're going to get one. So basically each of you is going to lead one. Well, you can all participate on each
other. So I can, my uber skill is sneak around.
Yep.
so I can be doing that while you're casing the joint or you're picking a lock or whatever and you're calling the crown.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's something we want to do after the 15 minutes. Like, we want to figure out what the whole plan
is. You plan first, and then you do your legwork.
So I'm curious what sort of major or minor waterways are near or ideally underneath, adjacent to.
Well, you know, it's a family-controlled district. The family controls the canals, so that there is probably one within reasonable proximity. Within a block or two.
Okay.
What is, as a member of the Red Lotus Society, what is my relationship and my organization's relationship with the family at this point in time?
All the cartels have a somewhat cooperative and somewhat contentious relationship with each other. The Red Lotus is a fairly powerful and fairly widespread cartel. Similarly, the family is the oldest, most powerful, and wealthiest cartel. So there is some friction there because your cartel tends to be a relatively major challenger to their authority.
I see.
Not quite as bad as the conflict between, say, the family and the circle, but...
I have a question about the game.
Okay.
If we had chosen the family, would the person who controlled the canals be a different family?
No.
Okay.
No. Well, when you guys play through a scenario, all I have back here is the things that are true about places, people, things, events, etc. So you guys are basically coming up with your plan. This is what's true. That doesn't change depending on what you guys are playing.
Okay. Another question I have is that, sorry, Kate, just a second. Noble can wait her turn. So in the planning phase, we're going to be like, all right, we're going to case the joint. Mm-hmm. And then when we case the joint, we will get information that I would then assume to use in when we actually do the thing.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So for me, it's like, how do I plan that part without that information?
Right. So basically what you guys want to do now is come up with as much of a plan as you can. You'll get a little bit of information from the from doing the legwork. And then you'll have another planning scene before you actually pull off the heist.
Okay, so there's another planning scene.
Yeah,
awesome.
Sorry.
Let me describe to you guys my particular talents by reading to you off of this card.
Amazing selfies.
You can find a way into any building in the city. You can enter any building without being seen or heard by way of any floor you choose in a manner in which you describe. You automatically succeed without rolling dice on any check you would make to pick a lock, climb, jump, tumble, or sneak around to do so based on your description. Once inside the building, the judge may require you to make rolls to remain undetected.
Are you the judge?
I am.
Okay.
So I'm going to say that's my legwork. I can get into this joint.
So you can do that one scene per day or night period, so you'll be able to use that over and over again.
Okay.
So you can do it for legwork to get inside,
okay,
and that's totally fine.
Okay. And can I do it to get outside?
That is the key, is you can get in, but getting out is going to be part of the scene.
Okay.
I am really good at attacking people, and I can decide whether they make noise or not when they are taken down.
That went a completely funny way in my head. It's like you heard somebody and you just pointed them laugh.
You laugh.
Yes. Exactly.
Fart noise. All right.
Make goat sounds. Do it.
It doesn't say you can determine the sounds that they make, but that sounds
that
like
is,
an awesome.
That is
I just suggestions for an expansion.
Okay,
I'm not.
Girl,
I'm the
okay.
You're the creator, but. So I also can sneak around. So if you get in and you need someone to get out of the way, I can do that either as a distraction and be like, yodel, bitch. Or I can be like, okay, now all of a sudden all the guards have vanished and we don't know why they've gone.
Can I suggest that to you as like a battle cry? Yodel, bitch.
Nice.
Yodel, bitch.
Yeah. Good.
So it sounds like you guys have two pretty clear legwork scenes. One is checking out the exterior and surrounding area around the 14th precinct, and it sounds like you're probably also going to go in and check out the interior as well.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay, so that sounds like a good two. You're obviously going to lead the one where you go inside. Probably one of the two of you is going to lead the one where you check out the outside. There you go.
Well, no, he can do outside. I want to do inside.
You can go in with her as well.
Is there a bar near here that
near the precinct house?
Near the precinct house, where maybe the guards in the precinct would go and drink after work?
There absolutely could be, yeah.
Because I have an 80% chance to outdrink somebody.
That seems good.
And I feel like if I can get somebody really drunk.
You have
drunk,
a percentage for that?
Yeah, it's awesome.
I can
that maps correctly to real life.
Yeah.
I can gain the use of a gambling hall.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
For a scene. Yeah.
This might not even have to be a scene. We can just go gambling.
Yeah. If there's a situation in which we're luring guards away, I have some
Is there
specialties.
A gambling hall near the precinct?
There could be, sure.
All right.
It's probably going to be a commoner's gambling, so like a card room, basically, sure. Like a poker
Sounds
room type
good.
Place.
Yeah.
I fit right in.
I can spend my influence to gain the use of a gambling hall if you want a private soiree kind of situation.
We could do that. I mean, is there any other...
It might not,
want to save
not need it?
It.
Yeah. Let's save it.
But it sounds like what you're basically going to be doing is setting up a scene where you are getting information from the guards that are off duty.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we're getting them hammered.
So, I have a question.
Yes.
What is the district... Sorry, because I have passed safely through Old City as one of the ways.
The Old City is basically, think of it like the Seattle Underground. It's mm-hmm. the old city that burned down and then got built over. So it's this whole subterranean realm that is sort of the domain of degenerates and...
my people?
The Forgotten.
Is that what you're talking about?
It is, in fact, yes. But it's basically...
Right.
Yeah, it's like
He's
the city's underground.
Chud. He's saying that there's chud.
Yeah.
You guys yeah. chud.
There's chuds.
Okay, well, the Twerkin family is respectable among the Forgotten and the Commoners, so I will pretend that you didn't say that. So
trash.
I don't have to stab you.
Where do the Twerkins hail from? Where do they? Where?
Yeah,
what's
where
their origin?
They hail
of the
from?
New England Twerkins.
Okay.
How can I tell if like there is an entrance into this prison / What were we calling it? The
precinct house.
Precinct house.
Yeah.
House. Thank you.
Yeah.
I keep forgetting that as well.
From the old city.
I think it's Scotch.
into the Scotch house. is there an entrance in through the old city? Is there a way for me to find that out?
So there's almost certainly at least corridors and tunnels underneath it.
Okay.
And then finding an entrance or finding a way up to the precinct house from underneath would be fine. So basically, you would be able to spend your influence. That's one of the things you can spend influence mm-hmm. on to gain access to those tunnels that would lead you up underneath it. So, yeah.
Okay, so that's something I think that I can offer that's probably the most useful. I can do a lot of, like, I can prop a door or window open by a member of the cartel, but, like, I don't think that there's, like, a prop a window and then there are bars. I don't think that's necessarily as useful. Or I can have the street urchins or, like, street gangs to do a distraction, basically.
Yeah.
So I think if we want to go overground, I can offer a distraction so that the guards are feeling like they have to go do something or that a merchant has to be distracted. Or if we go underground, I've got that on lock, which I think is strong.
All right. So it sounds like the three of you have pretty clear legwork scenes that you know you want to do. Lane, what are you thinking?
I am actually definitely thinking post up somewhere that is a reasonable public space, so cafe, bar, park, what have you, looking innocuous as possible in that space, so eating, drinking, or being mm-hmm. drunk on a bench mm-hmm. for each of those spaces.
In a robe and a...
Exactly.
In a robe and a
that's your wheelhouse right there.
Don't worry, yeah. I've got started. And I actually literally want to sit and case the joint, and what I want to find out is what does the guard contingent look like there?
Okay.
Are there any nobles that I recognize yep. or any people of importance I recognize that might be in leadership there? And okay. what does the changing of the guard look like?
Okay.
There?
That
Those
sounds,
are the things I'm interested in.
That sounds good. So it sounds like EGU has a pretty good idea what your legwork scene is going to be. Yes, Liz.
So,
you don't have to raise your hand.
My associate,
teacher,
Ms. Twerkin, has a question.
I have
yes,
a question.
Ms. Twerkin.
Thank you. So for instance, for this legwork scene, uh-huh. I would like to see if there is a safe or like cool entrance
yeah.
from the old city up. Do I have to spend my influence to search that?
If you're going by yourself, probably not, because
okay.
that's your cartel's thing, but you spend influence to get access for like everybody to go
right,
through.
Right.
So basically, like if you're going through the old city, they're just sort of like, yep, you sure, you're a member of our cartel.
Right, because I want to spend this influence for when
we actually
do it. But
if you bring strangers down here,
no.
that's what you'll be
no,
doing.
No, I hate these people.
Perfect.
I don't want to introduce them to my friends and family.
Wunderbar.
I don't want to go anywhere near the old city, thank you.
Oh, she's on old city duty.
Yeah. All right. So looks like the timer is pretty close pretty close to running out here. So I think maybe we just go ahead and call this planning scene done and get right into legwork. Perfect. Okay. So based on the things that you guys told me, I think the order we want to do this in is we probably want to start with with Rodman Rothman. How could I possibly forget that? With Rodman Rothman's legwork scene. So. One thing that happens is every day or night segment that passes, you guys generate some heat. Heat is a resource that I use to introduce complications into the game. So each of you generates one heat at the start of each day or night segment.
And this just represents us being criminals in the world.
Yeah, that's just sort of like, okay, the forces of the city's government.
Are these the final?
They're actually hot.
Yes, so that's because I've been holding on to these.
Sorry.
These are awesome.
Oh my god.
It's actual heat.
Rodney, you might have a fever.
I may be ill.
I got a fever.
Come on. Yeah.
Do we each get one, or is it sort of a group thing?
It's a pool that is basically out there that I will
inspect. So in previous games, these have been, I believe, pandemic cubes, so these are way cool.
Yeah. This is awesome.
Yeah, these are the campaign coins.
They have come out so awesome.
They are super cool. Okay, so Lane, why don't you go ahead and use the legwork template on the back of the specialty sheet and describe how this scene starts.
Well, I believe what actually is the case is there's an outdoor cafe and market sort of area about a half block from there.
Okay.
I forget the name of it, but I know basically where it's at.
You drank your memories of that name away?
Yeah.
Okay, sounds good.
Yeah. And I'm going to go and post up, frankly, like an old washed out looking dude with a periodical and a something in a bag at a table. And I will eat snacks from whatever the establishment is there and occasionally look like I'm dozing off. But I literally want to watch the comings and goings all day long of that place.
Okay. So,
you guys seen Hell or High Water?
Yeah. So
I want to post up like he did on that frickin'
bank. Wait, what's in the bag?
What's in the bag?
What is it? Like a cat or is it a?
We're rolling for quality right now.
It's
bad.
Okay, it's not good. Okay,
like a drink.
That was a 0-6.
Oh,
so
God.
sitting outside the precinct house in this sort of outdoor market area, one of the things that you're going to run the risk of is there are pretty regular patrols by the city watch. It's a commoner's district, so they're not super frequent, but there are pretty regular patrols by the city watch that come through here. And because you guys are all members of the cartels, there's always the risk that you, for your previous crimes, may be recognized for things that you've done by some of the city watch and patrol. There's also going to be just like the city's population coming by. And one of the first questions I have is, this is a commoner's district. Are you conspicuous in commoner's districts?
Where does it tell me on the new sheets where I'm conspicuous?
It tells you under appearance.
Yep.
Yeah, of course.
So you are.
I am not. I'm
okay,
like
not.
At home. I'm all like, right. Hey, Joe.
No, you're not. Okay, so
I'm
you're
not.
Good.
Yeah. I wouldn't want to be inconspicuous in
so
a commoner district.
Anyway. Since one of the obstacles is you're that he might be spotted by a city watch patrol out here, one of the things you guys can do is one of you can go along with him to basically help him overcome that obstacle in some way. And it's completely up to you how you want to overcome it, whether you just want to like stand guard and look out for city watch coming by, or you want to try and distract them. Whatever you want to do is fine.
Can I do both? Because I want to go into the underground.
And just stab
this
him.
Is
yeah, so
in
this
addition to your leg.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah. So basically everyone gets to lead one.
Okay.
And then you can also participate in as many other legwork scenes of other people's as you want.
I'm going to get drunk with you because that'll help you with that.
Can you talk to whoever it looks like the appropriate block locals are and just ask for some sort of signal if it looks like the fuzz are coming by and agitated? That's what we call them in the industry. They're called the fuzz. It means the police.
Right. Yeah, we got it. The city watch.
I threatened to like have their jobs or anything.
You
like
could,
that?
Okay. Since you were conspicuous in this district, you would generate some heat just by going along in this part.
Okay.
But that is something you could do.
I don't feel that this is necessary, Pomplamoose.
Okay. All right.
Very
so,
well, Redman.
But it sounds like Fast Betty is going to be going along with you. So you set up.
You do you have a nickname? Can I call you Big Rod Rodman?
Let's figure it out, but I know there's a better one than that.
Okay.
All right.
I just don't know who Big Rod.
So,
Rodman, Big Rod, the Rothman.
So, Fast Betty, you're going along with Rodman Rothfuss. Rodman Rothman.
Rothfuss.
Rothfuss.
You watch it,
hey, buddy.
Yeah, sorry. Words are hard. So you're going along with Rodman Rothman, and you're basically going to be helping him deal with the fact that there are patrols of watch and people around. Tell me exactly what it is that you're going to do to help protect him from their prying eyes.
Okay, so there are a couple of things that I can do, mm-hmm. and I'm just trying to figure out how to do this. So can I just murder everyone that looks at him? No,
that seems like that
so
could be
crude.
A problem.
So it looks like I can gossip with commoners or stab someone.
Actually, gossip with commoners sounds great.
Yeah.
Because then you can sort of apply it towards what we are
Yeah, I only have it on 65%, which is surprising. I guess
You could brawl with someone.
I could brawl with someone to create a distraction.
You're better at talking than you are at or better at fighting than you are at talking.
Oh, that's so me.
You could basically start a brawl to act
as a
distraction.
I walk in, take a chair, and just smash someone on the head.
And just say, don't look at him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Don't look at him.
Yodel, motherfucker!
Look at me!
All right.
And then there's like a montage of like crazy...
Yeah, so he's in like this outdoor market, and there's probably like a walk-up wine or ale stand that you could basically go up to, pick up a stool, and smash it over somebody's head and start a fight if that's what you want to do, right?
That's what I want to do.
Okay, so you're doing this to basically create a distraction.
Yeah.
Okay, that sounds good.
Unless this is going to harm your ability to take it down.
Let me get down, I can't see.
Right,
exactly. I would say let's post up near each other, but not together.
Not right on top of each other.
Yeah, exactly. Let's not sit at the same table, but let's sit within like mumble distance.
Okay.
And then if things start to get hairy, you can make your distraction.
Okay.
And I'll act aghast at the street violence.
What?
I'll bring pearls to clutch.
Okay.
Pearls are being clutched. Okay. All right. So what I want you to do is I want you to give me a roll. You're going to roll to brawl with someone.
Okay.
I'm going to give you one challenge die on this because it's a very public place and there's always the risk that this could attract more attention than you actually want. So what you're going to do is you're going to roll your percentile dice. Mm-hmm. You're going to take one of those black challenge dice there and you're going to add it to the roll.
Okay. I have advantage dice against minions.
Okay. Yeah. Sure. This is going to be just like a random person, so go ahead and throw that in as well. Yep.
Okay. Well, and I wasn't going to fight until people check us out.
Little did this guy know getting up today that he was going to be a minion in a random bar brawl.
That's right.
Okay. What is that? 60.
60.
Okay. So 60, and you have a 65% chance, right?
And then nothing came up on the advantage dice, and then
one drawback.
One little skull.
Okay. All right. So 60 is 60 is.
I'm sure.
So
60 skulls are good, right?
60 is under your chance of success, right?
Correct.
Okay, great. So that means you succeed.
What is the 80% for the skill level?
That is what you're trying to roll under.
Oh, okay, no. Under that.
Yes,
oh,
exactly.
Okay.
80% chance to succeed. So you did. So you succeed, but you rolled a drawback. What that means is you accomplished your goal. You managed to distract people well enough that he is not going to have to deal with any city watch poking their nose in. However, the drawback means that something extra kind of goes bad, right? It's not awful, right? You only rolled one, but it means that...
My three fingers? No.
It means that something doesn't quite go your way. So why don't you tell me a little bit about what happens during this brawl that attracts unwanted attention?
You know that scene in Serenity where, what's her name, River Song is like doing the whole thing in the bar fight? I'm sure it's just like that.
In the brown coat bar fight?
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Okay. Sure. Exactly. It's kind of like that. I'm
okay.
Amazing.
Okay.
Actually, this was perfectly with what I thought I was doing because I think I'm just kind of drunk at like picking things up to get them out of the way.
Yes.
Yeah,
exactly.
So you're saying like some kind of martial arts master?
Well, I'm an assassin. So
yes.
What happens?
So you're basically too good.
People notice that it's me fighting rather than like a bar fight distraction. So I'm still a distraction, but I think I got more attention for
your
being
fighting is so beautiful.
Too good.
Right.
All right.
Yeah.
So what that does is
tell me your biggest flaw. My biggest flaw is that I care too much.
Right. I'm too amazing. So what that's going to do is that drawback that you rolled is going to add 2 heat to the heat pool.
Hi, Chihuahua.
All right.
It's getting warm.
So, a little hot. So,
no, those are just been in Rodney's hand as well.
Yeah. It is actually true.
In his pocket next to some gummy bears.
All right, so Rodman, you take advantage of this bar or of this fight out in the marketplace to basically slip away, keep out of sight of any city watch who basically are then converging on her to basically check out what this fight is, and so you have pretty much free run of the exterior of the building to look around. Go ahead and give me a roll to case the joint, and because she was so amazing at this, I'm going to go ahead and, because she was so amazing and is drawing so many people, I'm going to give you an advantage down on this roll as well.
Delightful. I am delighted.
Yes! Oh, I don't know what it means that you got a thing on the dice that I did not
get. I have a house with a map token in it.
That's not accurate. Okay.
No,
you get a boon. All right, so you have a boon.
So I have a boon, and I passed with 43.
And you succeed.
My case of joint is 90.
All right, so I'm going to give you a little bit of information, but then I'll give you some more later. So as you check out the exterior of the building, you can tell that there are, let's see here, This is obviously a very old building. You notice that there is a plaque on the outside that identifies it as a historically protected building. It predates the fire that destroyed Dunhaven and is one of the few to survive that fire. As a result, it is very old, not very sturdy, and does not have many of the alchemical protections that modern buildings have.
Burn it!
Additionally, you notice that there are thief signs scratched on a post outside of the precinct house that read, "Light danger, lazy by day, corruptible at night, no deception by day, family neutral by day." So that's what you get just for casing the joint. That's what you see as you check out the exterior of the building.
Can you read that
one more time? Sure, no problem. The thief signs read, "Light danger, lazy by day, corruptible at night, no deception by day, family neutral by day."
So corruptible at night, does that mean we can, like, bribe the guard?
It doesn't necessarily, you don't know exactly what it means, okay. But, you know, that's the information. So other thieves have carved these signs onto the building to indicate this information to you.
For the right kind of people, like, this is just sort of shared information.
Exactly, yes. Okay. And family neutral probably means that whoever is running the place during the day, that they are not actively hostile to the family, which means they might be on the take, but you don't know. Okay, so that's what you get just for casing the joint. Your boon actually gives you a little bit of extra information. As you're casing the joint, you notice that there are two people that don't seem to be distracted by the brawl, and in fact are still sitting like on upturned barrels in the alley across the street. They are a tall, slender man. He's like 6 feet tall, really skinny, but he's got two hand crossbows hanging off of his belt, and then a shorter, sort of plumper, smiling woman, kind of looks like somebody's mom, is hanging out there talking to them.
But classic ruse. Yeah.
But you recognize them immediately as bounty hunters.
Ooh.
All right, so that is Sebastian's.
I walk up to them and ask, what are you bounty hunting?
So that is Sebastian's legwork scene.
It's right on the nose, huh?
So I think the next one we want to go to is probably...
Thank you, everyone. Pamplemousse. Actually.
Yeah. So, Pamplemousse Lacroix, you are going to be infiltrating the interior of the building try and get an idea of what the layout of the inside is as well. Okay. Obviously, getting inside the building is something that you can do. Getting back out is going to be the trickier part.
Right.
There are lots of guards inside here. It is a jail, after all, so there are people imprisoned and people being guarded. So you're going to have to deal with a fair number of city watch officers on the inside that are going to be very curious why you are in there. Is anyone going to go along with Pamplemousse to help her with her escape or anything like that?
Hey, smelly boy. You
want to
come with me?
Yeah. Can I lend her a vial of something? I'll go with her, but can I equip her with a vial?
A poison?
Yeah.
Sure. So actually, we sort of blew right past it, but in the planning scene, you could have created a vial of poison. So we'll just retroactively say that whatever it is you wanted to create,
nice.
You did.
Best GM ever.
Let's say it's going to be a poison that's in a test tube that you have to inhale.
Okay.
But it'll knock people out.
So it's the opposite of smelling salts.
Yes.
Okay, great.
Great.
All right, so you can give that to her. That's fine. The question is, does anyone want to go along with her to help get her out?
I don't want any help getting in or out.
Okay.
Whoa!
Wow. Misconfidence.
These people will only hold me back. No offense.
I can use my dice to smack her in the face.
Please, please stop there.
Well, I am going to sit back, eat popcorn, and
we'll
be delighted
see
to
goes.
See her succeed.
Now, I will, in all seriousness, I am willing to let you guys know what my plan is in case it goes awry and I need help. Can I do that?
Yes. So there is a way that if no one chooses to go along with you now and things go south, there is a way that other people could come along later.
Okay. Should I inform them? Well, I guess they're going to find out as soon as I do it. Okay.
Not a huge secret.
So I do have that second story work. I can get into this building, no problem.
Yep.
Excuse me. Sorry. So I'm in the building now.
So why don't you tell me how it is?
And I got in the building, and I won, and everything's good.
Tell me how it is that you break into this prison,
okay?
Into this jail.
So it says I can get into any building without being seen or heard by way of any floor I choose.
Yep, that's right.
How many floors does the building have?
One.
Okay, so I'm gonna go in on the first floor.
Okay.
Good start.
Yeah.
Seems good. Seems logical. Yeah.
So I assume since I can get in without being noticed, there must be windows or back doors that are unguarded that I'm able to get inside of. Is that
sure.
True?
Sure.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to choose a back door.
Okay.
I'm going to go in the back door.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So basically, yeah, what you discover is that there is, in fact, a door that is around. There's like a wooden palisade that surrounds the entire building. And then there's a yard where horses are tied up and coaches are parked around, like, to the side and to the back.
That's
and
a good flaw.
From this horse yard, there is an entrance that looks like the city watch used to go in and out.
Okay.
So it's normally kept locked. But seeing as how you're an expert thief, you pick that lock, no problem, and are able to slip inside.
Okay.
So your goal here, excuse me, your goal here, if I'm not mistaken, is to find out as much as you can about the interior layout of this building. Right?
Specifically where this prisoner, Alvinius Grimes, might be being held.
Okay.
And how many cells, how many guards. My plan is to lock myself into an empty cell until nighttime.
Oh, okay. So you want to stay in there.
Yes.
Wow.
But you can't give us the information then.
Well, I'm going to get him out. You guys are just going to be ready for me and another dude. Yeah.
Well,
that's my plan.
Okay. Well, then you didn't tell us during the planning phase.
All right. Well, come back at me then.
Okay. Well, then I would like to participate. Your issue is getting out. So
right.
Why don't we use the underground tunnels to get you out?
Beautiful.
Well, so these are all things that you absolutely can do. For the legwork, though, if you are going to try and go in and basically stay in there until nightfall,
mm-hmm.
that's really all we're going to worry about for like the actual legwork phase. Right?
Okay.
What you're talking about with staying in there and basically springing him out from the inside,
mm-hmm.
that's definitely something that you would do as basically a part of the execution of the plan.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So we'll like all you have to worry about at this point then is getting in,
getting
encasing
info.
The joint,
right, right.
and then making and basically blending into the population of prisoners without being like, without arousing any suspicions.
I did wear like my second best dress today, but like I can be rowdy as hell. If that's what they need to do.
Right, you could rip it a little.
Yeah.
Rough it up.
You are a noble, so they know who you are.
They might.
Oh my God, you are so high maintenance.
I know. so yeah, so what I want to do is get information about how crowded this jail is,
right.
how many prisoners, how many guards, sneak around until I can get that information, and then try to find an empty cell.
Do I have skills in prison fight?
And you do have the ability to fight with people.
I've got 65%
in
case
like hell.
I would say you're either casing the joint, or you could also use sneak around if you have sneak around, because that's another one.
Same skill.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
I'll let you choose whichever one you want.
Okay.
So you are trying to sneak around the inside of a district jail,
right.
which means that there's a lot of guards there. There's other prisoners there as well
right.
that are going to be surprised to see you.
Sure.
So you're going to make this roll. I'm going to give you three challenged guards, and then one from other prisoners who could basically
the black ones?
Yes, that's that can basically blow your cover. Now, before you make this roll, I'm going to say that if anyone else wanted to jump into the scene at this point and provide some help on this, you could. Don't feel like you have to, but you
this
could basically
is not my scene, man.
You could basically spend
like
20 of your
literally and figuratively.
You could spend 20 of your luck
possible
to jump into the scene mid scene.
Wait, we have luck.
We have luck.
Yes.
What's luck?
Luck is basically your hit points. Yeah, we didn't explain that.
No.
Luck is basically your hit points. When you take damage or whatever, it's going to come out of your luck. You can also spend luck to join a scene halfway through. Like, oh, it's a lucky thing. I was just right around the corner. You also use it to, if you fail a roll, you can use it to basically push yourself to a success at the risk of other complications.
What if I roll, like, can I use luck to negate a complication?
You cannot.
Can these...
If they join the scene, they can basically help you, which would let you add advantage dice. Advantage dice, their boons could cancel out the drawbacks.
And they have to do this before I roll.
That's correct.
I would like to assist, but I'm not quite sure how I can add advantage dice.
Well, you basically just tell me how it is that you're going to help her sneak around inside here and not be noticed. So, for example, you might say that you let yourself get arrested in that last scene. And are also on the inside with her if you wanted to.
That's a great... Yes, that's the thing I did.
you planned that all along.
I let myself get arrested in the last scene.
That is such a good idea.
Yeah,
thank you. It was
how
my
do you
idea
think
all
of
my
these
own.
I'm
it's
your
a genius.
It's your first time
it's
playing.
Amazing.
I'm amazing.
Okay.
So I let myself get arrested, and
okay.
I'm in the jail. So you
so
wanted to know how I get in.
So you spend 20 luck.
Okay.
That basically represents you're joining the scene mid-scene. Okay?
Okay.
So you spend 20 luck.
Out of 100.
Out of 100, yep. Now, you're in the cell right now, basically watching people, you know, or watching the prisoners, and you see her sneaking around. What are you doing from inside the cell to basically help her sneak around without being
noticed?
You're
squawking like a chicken.
Little bitch.
I would like to make a shit ton of noise. Okay. Am I sharing the cell with anyone?
I don't know. Are you?
Yes.
Okay. Sounds good.
So I'm going to brawl.
Oh, okay.
With the people in the cell.
So you're basically going to be a rowdy prisoner that is going to get the guards to come over and basically say, you know, knock it off,
right.
Stop, break up your fight to distract them from her sneaking around.
Right.
Or a one-stop distraction shop.
I am
so good at sneaking.
I'm a really good assassin who's great at getting attention.
Okay.
So she's also assuming that she's gotten herself arrested. She's gathering information about the prison as well, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna give you. You'll have an advantage die for her help.
Thanks,
okay.
Babe.
You're welcome.
But I still got these three, huh? Mm-hmm.
Do I need to roll? For
you're good.
Okay.
Yep. You're in. You're in and helping.
So is that usually how the assists work?
At
this point, like, person comes in, describes some aid. Aid alters the primary person's mechanics.
Yep, that's
and
exactly
what
right.
Doing again.
When you help somebody else, it adds an advantage die. Yep.
That's great.
Cool.
All right. Give
can
it a roll.
Can I roll now?
You can roll now.
Oh, hey, one of them is blank. That's good. That's good.
Okay.
Well, and one of them's
we only got one through. That seems
so
great.
Did I get a 69?
Nice.
Nice.
So I did.
Nice.
Okay, so I got a boon.
Let's all be adults about this.
Two complications.
That's not fun.
What?
There's no adults here.
She succeeded. That's what I was saying nice about.
Yeah.
Excuse me, sorry.
Okay,
good job.
So it looks like you got a success, and
yep.
You rolled two drawbacks and a boon.
Right.
Now, the boon and the drawback, one of the drawbacks cancel each other out,
great.
Which leaves you with one drawback.
Okay.
All right. So you're sneaking around, and you are casing the joint, getting all this information, but as good as her distraction is, it's not a completely foolproof distraction.
Should have known.
Why don't you tell me?
What if I show my boobs?
I don't think that's necessary in this, not on this live stream, anyways.
No, I meant in character.
Got it.
No, okay, that's fair.
That's terrible.
I can only do so. Sorry.
Seriously.
I can only do so much.
You're cut
I'm trying.
You're cut
no.
off.
So why don't you tell me a little bit about what it is that draws one of the guards' attention to you as you're sneaking around?
It's probably my gorgeous dress.
Okay.
It is shimmering in the limited light of the.
Why are you wearing that?
Because I wear it everywhere. God.
Does it have like light up?
The prisoner. Yeah, I love this because the prisoner just looks. He goes, "That is just not appropriate jail attire."
Excuse me.
Something's amiss.
All right. So here's
it's
what
like,
I'm gonna say.
Is that a Vera Wang? Yeah.
So here's what I'm gonna say. You have you've drawn the attention of one of the guards because of your fabulous outfit.
Mm-hmm.
You think he might be a little infatuated with you?
Yes.
As he's,
this
as
is one of the Vesper's qualities. Is seduction.
All right. So we're gonna say that infatuated guard's name is
Jebediah.
No, okay. That's way better than what I was writing down.
Jebediah. That's
right.
My favorite name.
So Jebediah.
Oh, I love it.
All right.
You seem interesting, different from the rest of the folk here.
I'm so sorry. I've gotten so lost.
All right.
Jebediah.
So Jebediah, Jeb to his friends, Miller is the guard who is
Miller.
Jebediah Miller is the guard who has basically
a little hurts around Jebediah Miller.
I think you can call him Jebby.
He's turned
Jeeps.
His attentions on you, Jeeps. And he's obviously quite infatuated. But that does generate two more heat.
A little bit of heat
as you're attracting more attention.
Feeling
no,
the heat, Jimmy?
Yeah. All right, so you got a bunch of information on the inside. You find Grimes. He is unharmed. He is by himself in a jail cell as well. But now you have put yourself into a cell. Are you in your own cell? Are you in Grimes' cell? Or are you in the same cell as Fast Betty?
No, I think I'll lock myself in with Grimes.
Grimes, okay, you and Grimes,
on.
No problem,
yeah.
Perfect. Sounds good. All right, so that's your two legwork scenes. So let's see here. You wanted to go and find an underground entrance, but it seems as though you have gotten yourself arrested in the meantime. So
there's two ways to find an underground entrance.
Yeah.
One is from the bottom and one is from the top.
Yes. I am going to pick a lock. to get out.
Okay, and are you basically, so it sounds like what you want to do then is you're still trying to find that entrance to the old city, mm-hmm. but you're going to pick a lock to get out of the cell, search around the interior and until you find it, is that right?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. Sneak around the interior.
Yeah, that sounds good. All right, so you're going to do this. It's still daytime. There's still guards around. You've attracted a lot of attention recently from your brawling on the outside and your brawling on the inside. And basically all of your brawling has drawn a lot of attention to you. How exactly are you going
to
pull this off?
We have to have a talk about afterwards.
There's a social worker on the way. You're going to have to attend some counseling.
Yeah.
Can I get any backup? Are you...
She's there already.
Can you flash your boobs?
This distress does not come undone.
That's fair. No. That's fair.
Do you know what's involved in getting these clasps
I was so
undone
into
on the back?
This.
Right.
I have a tendency to do this, and it takes 10 minutes. There's 3 or 4 days.
I mean, I could probably do something.
Okay.
What are you trying to do?
So, I'm trying to get out of the prison, or if I can see an entrance from my jail cell.
You probably want to search around the interior is
yeah.
the thing, right?
Yeah, but I
but you need to get out.
I need to get out of the actual
cell,
right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm going to...
I've got distract someone.
Okay.
I could distract the guard. Is it Jebby?
It could be.
Is it Jebby?
It could be.
All right.
You also have the poison he gave you as well.
That's true.
Just a reminder.
That's true. Last case. I mean, Jebby seems sweet. I don't want to hurt him.
Okay, so you're basically going to provide a distraction for
sleep.
Her to sneak around the interior and look for that entrance to the old city?
Since Jebby is already infatuated with me, can I get an advantage die for her? Or at least one. Maybe two.
Yeah, that sounds good. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have you... You've already established that you have Jeb's attention, so you're going to roll sneak around.
Okay.
You're going to have 2 challenge dice from the from the guards. You're going to have the advantage die from her help, and and I think that's it.
Okay, sneak around.
I did what I could.
Got it. Okay, ready? Everybody, are you ready?
Before you roll that sneak around, first roll a lock picking for me.
Oh, God damn it, you figured it out. I was just going to be like,
that's cool.
No.
Why don't you pick that lock for me first?
Escape means nothing.
I love how you were trying just to sneak that
no,
pass.
Yeah, stop, right? You skipped it. I have 50% on lock picking.
You have, should have
good,
more than 50%.
Good Lord.
Is anything else?
Oh, anything else. Okay,
I don't have it. I feel like an assassin, that maybe that was a class that I took, but perhaps I didn't pay attention.
I think you
attended some. Yes!
All right.
26!
Hey! All right, you do it. You pop it.
All right.
So you pop the lock. So now
I
you're going to sneak.
And lock?
You pop and lock, and now you're going to sneak around. Now go ahead and roll with the 2 challenge dice and the advantage die to sneak around.
That was very exciting.
Jebby, who's your favorite poet?
It's Keats, actually.
All right. Oh,
so common.
86.
It's very common.
But fortunately, sneak around is 90%.
All right, and
killing
looks like
it over here.
Nothing
wow.
on the challenge
oh
dice.
Oh my God, the challenge dice, Blake. That's
okay.
amazing.
Do you have
and
a moon?
I got a moon.
Perfect. Wonderful.
From your girl.
What?
From your girl.
All right.
I hate nobles, but
moose, pamplemousse.
So. As you're searching around, it takes you a while, and you're kind of like darting around corners and like waiting until people aren't looking. But one of the things that you note
it's
is
catching,
that
right?
it is.
I'm
pretty
productive.
Whoa, fast Betty, Bamba Lamba. Whoa, fast Betty. I'm singing myself.
You're actually doing that in your head.
They're
like,
gonna mute
go
that
on
the VOD. Sorry.
You're doing that. You're doing that whisper singing yell though. Like, whoa.
So it looks like this building, despite being quite old, has been added onto a couple of times. But it looks like the oldest part of the building is actually what is now the break room and barracks area. And you think, actually, if you go back around to where the Jakes are in the back end of the building, that you can probably pry up a floor stone and get access to the subterranean areas of the city.
Sweet. I do that.
Okay. You can go ahead and, just get it ready, basically.
Well, yes, but that's also how I want to get out.
Okay, so
we do the heist.
Okay, cool. So you want to actually leave now and leave her in there.
Yes,
okay,
because I feel like it's important we tell the team.
Yep, that's fine.
That she's gone rogue.
Wow.
I just
met
a nice young man.
That's fine.
Hard
okay.
rogue.
And then I love. Let's have an epilogue to the story.
Yeah.
Where you guys get married.
And then we, heist the wedding. Like, we steal all the...
Well,
present.
So expansion.
Yeah. Yeah. Dusk City wedding planning.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's the hot new expansion.
In this story, Jeb is really Catherine Zeta-Jones at the end of the last Oceans movie.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Okay. Entrapment.
All right, so that was...
I want to steal the cake maker that they get.
That was Fast Betty's legwork scene. So now all that's left is for Sebastian. What do you want to do for your legwork?
Okay, so we are going to the bar that many of the guards would frequent.
Okay.
Who wants to go drinking, guys?
Well, she can.
Yeah.
I've been in a lot of fights.
Dude.
I need a drink.
Come? Yeah. I think the drinks on me.
Wondering if I'm going to show up, and you get there, and I'm there.
You're already there.
You can't even tell him
there.
Right.
Sorry,
okay.
I keep
so
to drink
sounds like the thing you want to get out of the scene is.
I want to see a couple things. One, I want to see if the guards will tell us their shifts, if there's anything that they can give us any information. But also,
how are you with commoners? Do you need me to help you with that?
I'm not really the best with commoners. I'm the.
You smell weird.
Yeah, well, you know, some things you gotta just roll with. But I smell weird in fancy clothing.
What are the things you know about? Sorry.
I know about churches, cemeteries, funeral parlors, warehouses, and
you
medicine.
Are a socialite.
I know. Do you know the conversations I've had about the city's mortuaries?
Oh, my God.
Stunning and riveting.
Oh. You're the guy at the party.
I'm going to hear about some of the latest advances in embalming.
Yes.
Would you like to take a pamphlet?
Formaldehyde.
Have you heard the good
chemicals.
News?
How did I get recruited into this?
But also, I want to see
Jeff,
if I can get somebody drunk
this.
Enough that they will switch to our side and help us enter in possibly the front door or help our escape out.
Let me back up real quick. So you pried up that floor stone and went down to the Undercity to leave. If you want, you could take her with you back to planning because you can get back in. Then, like, if you want to get back on the inside, you can get back on the inside. Like, you can break in anytime you want, basically.
If I'm leaving, why not just take Grimes with me?
Because as soon as you try and get other people other than the two of you out, that's gonna draw a lot of attention.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay.
I choose to leave her.
That's fine. Oh,
wow.
We're not friends.
Yep.
I know you're talking to her, but have you considered asking me if I want her to go with me?
I'm just saying.
I could get out of this place anytime I wanted to.
Yeah.
I'm just choosing to stay.
In the Okay. You and Jeb live happily ever after.
All right, so you go down to, what's the name of the tavern?
It's not nearly as good
Sometimes
as my own.
It's not as good as Rigor's and Mortis.
But it's the Ship's End pub.
Ship's End, okay, cool, sounds good.
Only the love is real.
All right, and so you're going to be trying
Ship's End pub there, Captain.
You're trying to loosen some tongues with a little bit of alcohol?
Oh, a lot of alcohol.
Okay.
Because I can literally outdrink somebody. I have an 80% chance of outdrinking
someone.
That's
a major skill.
Yeah. It's a life skill.
All right. So I'm going to let you go ahead and roll to outdrink someone.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I got to loosen my tongue.
All right. I'm going to get you to roll to outdrink someone.
Okay.
No additional obstacles in this particular scenario. But I am going to give you a challenge die because they are going to be suspicious of anyone trying to ask questions about the jail itself.
Okay.
This session not sponsored by.
Not sponsored
All right. So.
But local Seattle. All
right. So Rodman, you're also there in the bar with him, right?
Correct.
Are you conspicuous in commoners districts?
No, I'm
and
not.
And you're not either. Right?
I perfectly blend
okay,
in.
Great.
I am not. No.
So if you want to help him with plying these people with drinks and getting information out of them, you can. Just tell me how you're helping him.
I think that this is a place I come to. I keep on wanting to say watch the ponies.
No.
But there's no television.
There's no television.
That could mean something else in our setting.
There are nice little ponies clopping outside.
I think we're going outside. So I think what we do is other gambling aficionados gather in bars like this, commoner bars. A lot of us that are hard bitten down in our luck folk watch whatever the gambling events are or what the racing and gambling things are and come to these sorts of places. So
it's a pigeon fighting bar.
I think what I'm doing is I actually won big today.
Okay.
Whoa.
And I'm spreading that around the bar. And I'm buying lots of drinks.
All right.
So I'm going to spend my
influence to help him out. Okay.
Wow.
And that is going to be a liberal dosing of everyone with alcoholic beverages and glad handing and friending and, you know, getting rowdy in a nice little sort of scuzz bar.
Instead of pigeon
the
fighting,
of which,
can it be like turtle races?
Yes.
Yes.
Please go on, Robin.
The intention of which is to just get everybody drunk and friendly towards me so that he can actually just be part of the revelry happening and get in with some of the guards.
Yeah, okay. I'm just like hanging over like, hey.
Okay.
This is just on the verge
like
of a Bacchanalian
rug.
Affair. There's salami and hors d'oeuvres.
Right. What?
This
hey,
is
you
probably
you stayed in the jail.
This is probably the fanciest party that the Ship's End has seen in a long time. So
I actually bring in food is brought in from outside.
Okay, very nice. All right, so
it's still terrible,
like
but it's better than what's here.
Check with our Vesper about where to.
No, but see, this is a carefully. This is a. There's an edge to walk here, right? Like it can't be. You can't be putting on airs. You just
right.
have.
There you go.
Like we brought in slightly nicer food than the place has, but it's still.
Right.
It's like,
still commoners.
Like
it's
Pompamous
not Taco Bell.
It.
It's like Taco Time, right? Right.
Yeah. Exactly.
That's what
we're
saying. That's what
exactly.
saying.
I'm saying it's a.
It's like
one
pigs
step
in a blanket, but with
exactly.
the crescent roll, the Pillsbury crescent roll.
No tacos with chicken as shells, but there are Mexi fries.
Those chicken shells are great.
Okay, so anyways.
Ew. I'm so glad I'm in prison.
Jeb, you wouldn't believe what they eat out there.
So he's helping you, and he also spent his influence to help you as well. So you're going to add 3 advantage dice to this roll.
Yeah. Right, three advantage dice? Holy crap.
Wow, that's really good. Well, he used his influence.
He spent his influence.
Oh, yeah. Right, okay.
Oh, God,
so I'm sitting down talking with...
Thank you.
Reveling in all the
revelry. Yes.
All
right, sounds good.
Yeah.
And,
you seem like a reveling
kind
of guy.
Yeah, my clothing. I'm literally in a black suit with long black hair. Not emo goth hair.
Black
hair.
I'm sorry.
It's emo. Do you have the big doctor?
No, I don't have the big doctor. Like no, that's only when I'm concocting my poisons.
I see. You that's know, his professional attire.
Kind of helps.
He's business casual right now.
Smell. Yeah.
Didn't give me the roll.
I'm trying. I'm thinking.
I bless you.
Nice.
29.
No, I got an advantage, and I successfully outdrank somebody.
Okay.
Nice.
And no disadvantage. Nice.
Okay. So you're looking for a little bit of an inn here with the guards.
I'm trying to find a guard that could possibly help us in or out, or both, depending on his proclivities. I'm open to both. All
right.
And... you know, give us a little bit of more information about what goes on and when would be the best time for us to, if we were going to get somebody out of the jail.
Okay. Yeah.
When do we go about it?
All right. So here's the information that you get out of this conversation. And basically, as they get drunker, they start saying more and more. Obviously. So you get the pretty quick impression that the city watch officers that are in here now represent an entire shift. Like, basically, their shift ended and they all came down here. Okay. There's 6 of them. Okay.
Man, we are getting them drunk.
Yeah. Additionally, you know that there is a captain of the watch that's always on duty.
Okay.
As well.
Is the captain in this 6?
There is no captain with this 6 right now. Okay. This is also daytime.
Day drinking.
Here.
Woo!
We just became woo criminals.
Yes.
Not woo girls. Woo criminals.
Woo criminals.
It's not gender specific.
Yeah. So you find out that at
Working
night.
Opportunity criminals.
Yeah.
At night, the captain of the watch on duty is Emily Carver. She is a
Emily Carver.
Yes, she is a young, bright, and ambitious woman, and that basically she takes over at nighttime.
Does she have an affinity for men with long black hair?
Unknown. Unknown.
Can we roll for that?
Let's not use seduction as one of your techniques.
You also find out.
Come on.
You also find out that
50-50.
During the day.
Yeah. Anything else?
During the day, the captain of the watch is Delmar Brandis.
Delmar.
Yes, he is actually a noble. He's a minor noble. But Emily Carver is a commoner as well. So you remember you saw those thief signs, or he saw those thief signs outside.
That
said family. It said corruptible at night, family neutral during the day. Mm-hmm. So here's what you find out. You hear a story from these guys about Captain Brandis, who's the daytime watch captain, that basically he used to be an investigator for the Crown. Like, he was basically, you know, a detective effectively, sure. right? And he was really good at his job, put away a lot of criminals, and at one point he actually managed to build a case against a high-ranking criminal. When you hear this description, this sort of triggers your memory. Turns out there was a member of the Black Council, the sort of council that rules over all of the cartels, that was basically brought down by an investigator, and this is that guy. But that basically the family went to him and struck a deal with him and said, if you don't pursue this case against our guy, we will set you up. And he took the deal. So this guy, that's why he's family neutral, is because he took the deal from the family to not prosecute a member of the Black Council. But now he's the captain of the watch here at this precinct house.
In family territory.
In family territory,
but he's
exactly.
neutral.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. But corruptible.
You find out that there are...
Emily Carver's the one.
Yeah.
That there are two shift changes. Okay. There's basically one at... when daytime takes over to nighttime, and then vice versa. Mm-hmm. And then there's another one in the middle of each of those time periods. So basically, there'll be two groups of guards in the daytime and two groups at the nighttime as well. It is in the morning at dawn when Emily Carver gives over her shift to Delmar Brandis.
Excellent. I feel like this has been a very successful party we've had.
Yes, indeed. Okay.
Should I slip poison into, like, all their drinks?
I just want to poison someone.
Somebody. I want to get someone.
Get us heat, man.
Yeah, that's true.
Could be fun.
Could be fun.
Okay, but
Well, but you could. Okay, so you could put some... Actually, let's talk about the merits of that real quick.
Well,
okay, hold on.
You just kill all the guards.
No, not kill.
That
like,
solve
I'm,
a lot of my problems.
This isn't kill. This is like... Guards. I'm going more towards trigonosis. I really think... raw pork in their drinks.
Alrighty then.
Okay, so actually, something that I don't understand, and I apologize if you've already explained it, is I don't know what the heat is for, like how that affects
So
us.
I haven't spent any heat yet.
Yeah, don't watch out.
That does something?
At a certain point, I will spend that heat to introduce complications.
Well, isn't that... Oh, you monster.
I am a monster.
So you're building up reserves.
Indeed I am.
That seems broken.
This is a great time for you to review. So who designed this game anyway?
Yeah.
Monster.
All right. So that's the end of all your legwork, and now it's going to tick over into nighttime. Every time it ticks over to nighttime, adds 4 more heat to the heat pool. Oh, so let's see what we got out here right now.
Enough.
2, 4, 6, 8. That's going to add 4 more, so we're going to go up to 12. So there's now 12 heat in the heat pool.
Oh, right, of course.
Oh, you got big heat tokens?
I
got 5.
Oh, he's so cool.
He got big heat.
Yeah,
big
heat. So I got 5s.
Rodman got the heat.
Oh, that's his nickname now. His nickname is Big Heat.
Big Heat.
Cost.
Big Rodman.
They cost either 4 or 12 or 20.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
We're mid-tier here, folks.
Yeah. Okay, so... Now we're going into nighttime. It is nighttime, and one of your members is still in the jail. You guys, the three of you, can take a planning scene before you have to execute the job. So basically, at dawn, it'll take over to the daytime, but you got to do it right at dawn because the people in the castle are going to come. And it's in the morning, but basically that'll be considered the start of the daytime segment of the next day.
So I can't plan anything?
You will not be able to participate in this planning
you
scene because you are in jail.
I have to go to the bathroom anyway.
That's
so
totally fine,
perfect.
Yes. Okay, okay. So I'm going to go ahead and start this planning scene. This is a great time for Kate to take a break.
I kind of wish.
Yeah, I do have more snacks.
I kind of wish that I was in the prison cell because I also have to go to the bathroom.
All right. I can.
That's dead air.
I can stall for time if you need to go.
Why don't we start the planning scene and then when Kate comes back, she can take over for Lane.
Okay.
That'd be great.
All right.
Hello,
so
baby, if I haven't peed already, just sitting here.
So we got a 15-minute timer. I'm going to start the timer. Why don't you guys tell me where it is that you do this planning? Last time you did it in the mortuary. Where do you go to plan this time?
My boat.
I love it.
Okay.
You know, you do have a spectacular boat.
Yeah. All right.
Barnacles and all.
So your Red Lotus ship. All right. So why don't you tell me what the name of your ship is?
Oh, you son of a...
I know.
I'm not prepared
big
for...
Big Rod.
No.
Ramming Rod?
No.
Ramrod?
Ramrod. Car Ramrod.
Say it. Say it. Car Ramrod. Say it.
Say it.
Anybody else got an idea that's not Ramrod?
Oh. Rod Ram? Rod Ram. What?
This...
Mastermind of the Seas.
God, this is in your wheelhouse, man. Come on.
Lane, this is
the Salt Wife.
Salt Wife, nice.
Nice.
So good.
Nice.
All right, so on board the Salt Wife, you guys do your planning. I'm going to start the timer, and before I do, because you guys had such success casing the joint, I'm going to give you the full blueprints to the building.
We're in like Flint, people.
All right. Can you mark where we know Pomplamoose is, please?
What?
I can, yes. Hand it back to me.
Is it Flint?
It is Flint.
Can you hand
it back to me?
Let's get Rodney. Back to
All right.
You did it. You did what I was asking. Thanks.
You're pretty. All right, I've marked the cells that have Pomplamoose and Alvinius Grimes in them.
Yeah.
All right, Siri. So the timer is going.
Okay, so...
Oh, I thought she was in the same cell as Grimes.
Oh, she did put herself in the
so
same
she's
cell.
There.
Yeah, yeah, okay. So,
I mean, if I...
Yeah, go ahead. They're both in the one I marked with the P.
Oh, with the...
So we're going to have to do this during the daytime, then?
It'll basically be right as it ticks over today, yeah.
Oh, but we could convince Emily Carver...
The dawn hours.
...to let us in.
If you can find a way to make that happen.
Is it interesting to, as a contingency, do something to slow down the armored coach, which is coming to take him away?
I could.
Or do we think we can? So I guess I'll say this. Actually, that's where I had one initially, but that's just based on not knowing what we're planning on doing in the first place.
Right.
So just to clarify, yep. All the stuff that we did before was during the day after we got the case.
That's correct.
And so this is
nighttime.
Us leading up to.
It's like
the dawn deadline.
Yep, exactly.
Okay.
Basically, at dawn, it'll be the next segment, which will be daytime.
I brew a
You'll
nice
pull it off
of
then.
Sea
nice.
We're on the salty way.
Salt
you don't have anything else.
Is it in a conch shell?
Okay, go to the bathroom. Okay.
And just a quick review, the obstacles that you know about that you're going to have to deal with are the 6 City Watch officers that are going to be inside, the captain of the watch that's also going to be on duty, and then, of course, you know, breaking in and breaking out. But those are the sort of big obstacles. You also, I will point out, spotted another obstacle that wasn't apparent from the beginning, and that is the 2 bounty hunters sitting across the alley, across the street in the alley, watching the... watching the jail.
Okay, so I can use... So here's a question. I can use my influence to get us through the slums pretty easy. Does that mean that
through
I can
the old
then...
City?
Through the old city?
Yeah.
Sorry. Does that mean... Will I be able to use one of these to get us in and out, or will I need another one?
It allows you to travel through the old city for a scene, basically.
For a scene.
Yeah.
So... This whole thing is a scene, really, if you think about it.
Yeah.
So
the heist is like the final scene, the prison break is a whole scene. Yeah.
So I recommend that we use the old city, the underground tunnels
to get in.
The rest of the team to get in.
Okay.
And then for all of us to get there.
And I can quarantine the rest of the city so nobody or that district so nobody can come into it.
Right, cuz the bounty hunters I'm worried about, and then also the any exterior guards.
So you're basically going to use your quarantine to slow down the arrival
of anybody coming into the district.
Right.
So we can make our way
the coach,
out.
The armored coach, and everything.
Right.
Okay.
And I know that you have this all taken care of.
Obviously. Are we doing the smuggling out during the day or the night?
It's basically at dawn.
At dawn. So the shift change is happening?
Yeah.
Okay. Because I noticed that the day captain, I don't know if I've noticed this in character, but he is a noble.
Mm-hmm.
So presumably I could blackmail him with some kind of information.
You guys did find out that he was a noble.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Or you found out that he was a noble. Yeah.
Delmar Brandis, I believe. Mm. The Brandis family has many secrets.
We heard about that, and it's nice to be able to exploit him every once in a while.
I agree.
So can we bribe the captain of the guard to like do a drill where all of the other guards are then at a different location?
Oh, like he's going to send them out to kind of train them almost?
Right.
Yeah. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
They got to do some laps.
Yeah. Sometimes you got to keep your people fit. I mean, it's just a
right.
Sir, your guards are looking a little chubby.
Yeah. And you say one noble to another, you know.
That's right.
Get your men in shape.
Is there, so, Rodman.
Yes.
The original OG Rodman. Is there.
Not now.
Is there.
Nope.
Is there anything I need to do in order to have it's blackmail is a word that's used many times mm-hmm, in the Vespers. Mm-hmm. Do I just have that knowledge and can use it, or is there something that I have to roll in order to get blackmail information on Delmar?
So let's see.
Like, is she keyed into the city's secrets?
I feel like
almost?
I probably know a lot.
I feel like you've done your due diligence.
Right.
So you've been let's see here. You've been trapped inside this jail. Not trapped. You've been
for almost 10 minutes.
Right. You have been voluntarily locked inside this jail for the basically the whole day, right?
Uh-huh.
I would say that if one of these cats could send a message to you, then they could communicate that information that you need in order to do that.
If I encounter Delmar without them being able to communicate to me, would I be like, a Brandis. I know information about the Brandis family, and I can use it against you if you don't keep your stupid mouth shut.
I would say, let's see here, because you're locked in the cell and it is nighttime when all this planning is going on, Emily Carver is on duty instead, not him, so you wouldn't have that opportunity. But if, so for example, what you guys could do is spend your crew influence to have a corrupt watch officer deliver the message to her, and then you could spend your influence to affect Brandis.
Okay.
And that's just a result of the fact that, like, well, you're stuck in this jail right now.
Yeah, but I'm in there just reviewing all of the things I know about the Brandis family, and, you know.
You see, you don't even know, you don't even know he's
I
the captain
of I pop out
of
a stone
right
in the floor and shout up to you, hey!
That Brandis!
Just let us down there, then.
No.
And you're like,
too soon.
No. We got all kinds of phases to play in here. Okay.
We must make this more complicated.
What do you guys think?
Poison?
Jesus.
I got a one-track mind here.
I think that we, for me, I know that my influence token is going to be used for using the tunnels for the entire heist, which makes me comfortable. For Lane has already used him. I don't want to speak for him, but hold on.
Yeah, you gotta put that.
No, I can use my own influence to obtain information myself.
Oh, excellent.
So
just like from the old libraries, I guess.
Well, because we're looking at using influence to corrupt one of the guards to tell you this information.
That's true. Yeah.
To send a message.
I'm just trying to think if we need to use the crew influence.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I
failed to give you an influence as well. So when you chose to break into the prison, that was what I would call a risky or daring or exciting scene. I mean, obviously, you did something that was far more risky than just, like, having a beer at the local pub.
Listen, I could have poisoned myself with my own alcohol.
Also, because this is a new location where you're having this planning scene, you guys get another crew influence as well.
All right,
so
well, then let's do
resources.
It. Let's corrupt the shit
That's
out
my
of
bad.
These guys.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Best GM ever.
Also, should I make a poison or a vial?
God damn it,
Listen,
Sebastian.
Not a poison. I want to make a vial that, like, a ninja cloud where you throw it down.
You can absolutely do that.
You know what I mean?
Ninja clouds.
So if you guys wanted to.
That's it. And that's the move you got to make while you go through the cloud.
You're the guy in the team who's like, hey, guys, do we need poison? Poison over here. Spaceship. I'm like building a spaceship.
All my pockets are filled with poison. I'm like, no, please stop.
Ninja cloud.
No.
Come on.
Assassin.
So are you guys going to spend one of those crew influence to have a corrupt guard deliver a message to her?
I think that makes a lot of sense.
Great.
So let's do the crew influence.
Yep. Rodman, Roth, that makes perfect sense.
Roth.
It was his idea.
All right, so here's what you know. You now know all the stuff that I told him on the previous turn. So basically. Get in here.
He's back.
Yeah, so
you had a great idea.
I'm on board.
Yeah, a corrupt watch officer basically slips you a note through the bars.
Okay.
And it has all the information.
Okay.
Was it? It wasn't Jebediah?
So I know.
And you can have him deliver a message back out.
I know that Delmar Brandis, though he himself has not participated in such things, has overseen and covered up certain urination scandals.
Damn.
Too soon.
No, we did not. We just did, apparently. What you missed is we gained a crew influence and then we spent it to get a corrupt
guard to give
her message.
So really nothing's changed since you've gone.
Right, except now I know everything.
And she has two of these coins.
Yeah.
That's probably the net.
Because I broke into a prison and locked myself in a cell.
Yeah.
Dose coins.
That gives you cred. Street cred.
Dose coins.
So anyways.
Yeah.
You were saying.
Delmar Brandis, I have certain information. There are keywords that I can use in his presence to let him know that I know. And he's not going to want the rest of the City Watch, the rest of the Brandis family,
to find out the things that he's done.
Excellent use of names.
So maybe get the corrupt guard to be like, hey, Brandis needs to come over and talk to you.
Can we give our own team influence coins? Like, so I give you a Gravedigger?
You cannot swap influence.
No, I want to give her one of my influence coins.
Yeah, what is, like, this is just props. Yeah. You should make another third coin.
Yeah, I know.
Props like, coin.
No, yeah, look at this.
An additional currency.
Like four or five currencies. Right, yeah. Yeah.
With more cookies.
Community, you can make this happen. Demand that third coin.
You have earned one Nilla wafer. Congratulations. Right.
So, you're planning on spending your influence. Oh, yeah.
Sure can.
Yeah.
There we
Nicely
go.
Done, engineer. All right, so you want to spend your influence to affect Delmar Brandis, that's correct?
I do.
Okay. What exactly are you trying to get out of it?
I want him to make sure that we have a clear path to get to the underground tunnels and with no interference from the guards that are in the prison.
Right, so training exercises have been recommended?
Training exercises, or he sends them to a retreat.
You want him to basically tinker with the shift changes to make that possible.
Yep, I want full blackout along the path to the underground tunnels.
Nice.
Okay. At a specific time that we've all
agreed on. Very specific
time,
5-minute window that okay.
You're using your influence to deliver this message to him that
Correct.
Basically says, do this thing?
Yep.
All right. All right, so tapping into the Vespers, the deep ledgers.
Yes, and the keyword to send with the message is PP time.
Okay, then. I'm not going to say that.
I'm sorry, what was the keyword?
PP time.
Yeah. PP time, got it.
Okay, so, yeah.
Not to be confused with...
So because he's a noble and because you have access to the deep ledgers...
Whole different scenario.
Yes, we are professionals.
Because you're noble and you have access to the deep ledgers, you're able to basically send a message out with this corrupt guard
right.
that is there with you, and hopefully it means that Brandis will adjust the guard schedule.
Oh,
in your
he
favor.
Will.
All right, so there's a little bit of time left here in this planning scene.
Oh.
You guys have a couple more obstacles that you haven't really talked about yet. For
bounty
example,
hunters.
Bounty hunters.
But they're out front, right?
Do we still have a team?
You have that... You have that original vial of substance.
It's true, but the bounty hunters, I don't know what they're doing out there. They're just chilling.
Well,
what
and
is,
we're going
what is the
in
application
the tunnels.
Method of that poison?
But you're gonna use your influence to get the crown to
quarantine off the
which should get the bounty hunters off, right?
Well, they're already there.
They're
Nobody
there.
Will be coming in or out of the district.
Questions.
Oh.
Is there a readily available or readily
like,
enough that we could get it anecdote or block for that poison? Because... What I'm thinking is I could take the team influence, I could spend it on having some Red Lotus Society little brothers run interference on those bounty hunters and knock them out.
I'm just worried, you know, Johnny Heat over here could...
Jonathan Heat.
I have worried, yeah.
Spend that.
I kind of want to save this for whatever craziness is about to happen.
That's
I
true.
Mean, I think that the Rod Man is nice enough that he's not going to use this at all.
I will actually. So I will say this: we could do this retroactively if we need to. One of my things is, as a mastermind, I can spend a point of influence and sort of retroactively play out a little vignette and say, "Oh, but no, actually, this happened to counteract this thing that you're saying happened."
That's a good thing to say for during the
right. So that could be our backup plan.
So I have kind of a built-in contingency. To do the thing I'm talking about anyways without having to commit in advance.
Because I think what I could
do... So now I'm agreeing with everyone.
Okay. What I could do is I could... So where are the bounty hunters outside?
Yeah, across the street.
Because I think if they come in, I could probably also have an opportunity to do a silent takedown of them. Because I really want to
stab somebody.
Yeah.
I like that you guys said it to you. It's like, oh, she wants to stab.
I know her very well.
Don't criticize my poisoning ability. I'm like, stab.
After I stab them, you can do the poison.
Stab.
And it goes 6 years of stabbing school.
Yes.
Yodel bitch! Bah, 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 bah. So if that doesn't work, then we have poison.
Wait, what if we do a poison
combo
stab combo?
Oh.
Yes.
Poison. Like, boom, poison, stab,
that's
stab.
Yeah, while they're laying helpless on the ground asleep, I will just stab their corpses.
There's nothing more honorable than stabbing a recently poisoned person.
And then if those two things don't work, you can then do your thing. So I think
like,
we have
how
a lot
fast
of
can we make
no,
this
no,
go?
No, just watching that timer's running out.
So I think we have a lot of backup options for how we're gonna step by step. Or
okay,
I feel good about.
I have no idea
anymore. Yeah. You've got like 2.5 minutes figured out. What are you doing?
What I'm quarantining off the.
Okay, you're quarantining.
Do it.
Quarantine. Are you using that to quarantine?
Yeah, well I have to.
Oh, see. Okay.
And I'm making the ninja.
Jesus, the Ninja Cloud.
So you're making a smoke bomb, basically. Yes. Alchemical smoke bomb, okay?
You were talking
about. Wait a minute, yeah. You're a
talking
poisoner.
To the crown.
You're not an alchemist, you're a poisoner.
I am a. How do you say that word?
React?
Psychicer?
Physiker.
Physiker.
So, wait, I'm confused because originally you said you were going to use your influence to tell the crown to do a lockdown.
Yeah, he's going to do that.
Make ninja smoke.
That's what this is.
Okay, so.
You make poison, bro.
You make
poison, bro.
I have an incense burner hanging
listen, bro.
My jacket.
Listen, your skill set has a very narrow window. It's poison.
Poison, bro.
It's poison. All right, I think we're ready. I think we're as ready as anyone can be.
I think that seems correct.
Wait, hold it. Hold it. Wait.
Does the camera framing Rodney have the timer in it?
Yes.
Excellent.
Nice. Excellent. Okay, good.
Good and done.
Okay, okay. Now we're done. Wait, what? Oh, it's too late.
All right. Dawn breaks. Dawn breaks of the next day, and you know that you have a short window with which to retrieve both your boon companion and Alvinius Grimes, the target of this job. So, you are spending your influence to allow the crew to travel through the old city, correct?
Yes.
All right, excellent. Now, because you did the legwork to identify the entrance from the old city into the jail, you basically are able to go directly through the old city up into the, into the Jakes. So, traveling through the old city is like traveling through the underground of many cities. There are basically like shop fronts and building fronts that are completely underground, but it's dark, it's filthy.
Is it haunted?
It is not haunted.
You're not there yet.
Well, it is sort of haunted, but it's
doesn't like ghosts.
It is haunted by
It's haunted in a civic failure sort of way.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's even worse.
It's haunted
by it is for you, isn't it?
You're not
this
there
could
yet.
Have been avoided.
The further you go, the more depressed you get. yes. So, well, that's spectacular.
Too soon.
All right, so so you travel through the old city. It's dark. You've got like a lantern that's
it's
bathing
place.
The three of you in light, but not not giving much more light off beyond that. It smells bad down here. The sewage city sewers pass through here as well.
Don't worry, I'm bathing
before
you in
it
light.
Gets to a point, actually, and I forgot about this because I had to take a tinkle.
Yeah.
Before it gets to the point where I will retroactively do this. Optimally, I have prep work, which I actually think, which I want to use. So prep work allows me to specify one of you and specify one of your skills, and when you roll that in the next legwork scene, you get two advantage dice.
What?
Because we are working together on anticipating what, I believe, working together anticipating what the possible complications are.
Stab someone.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Do nothing.
Does anybody have so?
I have brawl with someone, which is not part of the plan.
Oh jeez!
What in the hell is that?
The daytime segment is starting. That's just four more.
So does anybody have a skill? So brawl with someone is one. Does anybody have other skills?
And also stab
suggest?
Someone.
Distract someone.
Outdrink someone.
Oh my god!
I don't have any plans to brawl with someone.
So is stab someone and brawl someone a different thing?
Yeah.
Delightful.
I mean, the same. I mean, I'm not going to say brawl with someone, but I've just been using it a lot, so I'm not sure what the idea
in
is.
The brawls,
well, actually, I would,
in the brawls,
actually,
there's
so,
no knives.
Yeah.
So, but the thing is, we anticipate our biggest problem potentially right now. I anticipate our biggest problem being the bounty hunters.
Yeah.
Because they're an unknown.
And yeah. I'm going to stab
them. Feel stabby.
I have an 80%.
Are you going to challenge them to a drink off?
Yes, I could. right in the front of the. I have an 80% distract someone.
I also.
But also, more importantly, I have a 65% run like hell.
Me too.
Me too.
I think we all have that, actually.
It's
a solid backup plan.
Okay, so we have a consistent 65%. Let's leave that there. We're going to live or die by each other.
Yeah.
Everyone wins but you.
Distract or stab?
Stab.
I that's what I'm saying.
Let's let her stab someone.
Yeah,
stab.
She's dying.
Right. I didn't mean for that to take as long as it did.
No, it's okay.
May I stab?
First play.
Please, may I stab another?
Please.
Okay, so you travel through the old city, and you emerge in the precinct house. It is just after dawn. You kind of know what the timing is going to be for this, so you're just sort of waiting in your cell. As soon as you see the sky start to lighten, you know that this time is coming. So you emerge up through the up through the Jakes and find yourself, I don't know if you saw this, but this is actually the entire map here. You find yourself coming up over here. You know that you're going to have to travel all the way around this way.
Is Jakes a phrase for bathroom?
Yes, it is.
Good to know.
All the way around.
Do you need to tinkle?
All
right, so for the sake of the audience, we're coming up here to the Jakes, the pee-pee rooms. And then we have to travel all the way around to the jail cells. Well, not me, because I'm already there. Right, yeah.
What? I would like to check the supply room. Actually, no.
All right. So
break room for snacks.
Yes. So the way this is going to play out is this is going to play out. This is going to play out as a drama scene.
Okay? Ooh, drama scene.
Yes, so this is a drama scene. What that means is that we're going to be taking turns. It's sort of like rolling initiative in other role-playing games. So what's going to happen is I'm going to go first and do like guards and other things that are going against you guys. And then after that, you guys all get to take a turn each. And then it goes back and forth and back and forth. So what's going to happen is we're going to do that until you have successfully exited the building or something else has otherwise gone.
Someone should successfully pass the booze.
Yeah, we need some
McCallum.
Yes, my question is, does the engineer need booze? But after that, when you say we'll go back and forth, does that mean that you, as the guards, go, and then Eric goes, and then you go again?
No.
Okay,
sorry.
So we each go.
It's sides. So your side, then my side, then your side, then my side, et cetera.
Pass the McCallum to the engineer. Pass the
mysterious
engineer.
All right.
Just get all excited.
Good.
All right, so Pamplemousse.
So yes,
You are in your cell, and you notice that after a while, you see the sun coming up, and you know it's about that time. And you notice that the guard presence in here is diminishing. Like guards are leaving, like they're going off shift, but no one's coming back.
No one's coming back.
They just go out, and then they don't come back. Mm-hmm. And they go out, and then nobody comes back.
Okay.
And it finally gets to the point where, instead of seeing, you know, a bunch of guards milling around, there's only, like, three of them, right? That basically, and even they're starting to wonder, like,
do they look like stupid? Are they the dumbest
right?
ones?
Do they look like they're going to go try to find the other guards?
Yes.
No, they just sort of look confused right now, right? They're just like, I don't know where everybody is.
Okay.
Additionally, about 10 minutes after you think that your friends are supposed to arrive, you see the overnight captain of the watch, Emily Carver. She comes into the room, and she's sort of slender but athletic, and she's got these epaulets that have her badge of rank in the city watch on. You see she's got a saber strapped to her hip. She sort of comes in and frowns and looks over the guard post at the end of the cell block, and you hear her asking the guards questions like, where is everyone? Do we have that many out sick today?
Okay.
This can't be right. Has anyone contacted Captain Brandis? He should have shown up to relieve me some half hour ago.
I have a distract someone skill. Can I distract her in any way?
Sure, we'll get to that on your turn.
Okay, okay.
Just sort of doing the guard's
turn. All right, you're
right
doing
now.
The guard turn.
Yep.
Wait, so Brandis doesn't show up to take over his role?
He has not yet. But
it's 'cause he was out late drinking.
She has managed to blackmail him.
Yeah.
She basically sent him a letter that said, like, I know what your deal is, and we're going to reveal it. I'm not going to say pee-pee time.
On your sheet.
Damn it.
On your sheet.
Boom! You did.
Mistakes were made.
On your sheet where it says, so what's your deal? We know what it says.
Yeah, yep. Exactly.
Yep. His deal is pee-pee time.
Yeah.
I will accept this, but I feel like the guards wouldn't have moved until he came on shift.
What happened was the message she sent basically said, get rid of the guards, right?
Yeah.
And so, like, as guards are leaving, they basically aren't being replaced because he rearranged the watch schedule. So basically, he cut the guard contingent in half, effectively, and then he's not showing up to relieve her. All right, so that is basically...
Are we rolling initiative or anything?
We don't need to roll initiative. It's just sides back and forth.
Okay.
So that is going to be all of the judge control characters for now. So now it goes back to you guys. So you had something you wanted to do?
Yeah,
Kate?
I think I should take advantage of this situation. And probably I need to distract Emily Carver.
Okay.
She is...
Tell me how you're going to do that.
Well, from what I understand from the correct
the corrupt guard's message. She's both young and ambitious. Oh. So I probably have some connections that can help advance her career, get her out of the 14th district nighttime shift.
Down. To the 15th Smart. District?
I or the 13th.
Oh, I don't actually know which way it goes.
I have connections. If you she's do. Willing to look the other way, well, I smuggle my good friend out who's been arrested for no good reason, might I add, then I could probably make some things happen for her in her career.
Okay. All right. So here I have two questions.
Do you want to do that so early?
The first question is, are you actually going to basically leverage your connections to get her a commission, or is this a lie? And the answer to that question is basically, are you going to spend your – you have one remaining influence. Are you going to spend your remaining influence to actually get her a commission?
Right.
Or are you – if not, and in which case you'll be lying to her.
Well, my lie is only 65%, so I think I probably need to spend something.
Okay. I love that idea.
All right. I like it. That's great.
Okay.
Okay. So basically, here's what you're going to do. You're going to make a roll to convince her.
Okay.
And – if you succeed, you'll be spending. You will just spend that influence to say, like, yes, you're going to use your influence to get
and
her a commission.
Am I using my distract someone?
I could say you can use either distract someone or convince someone. Either one.
I only have distract someone. I don't have convince
that's
someone.
That's fine.
So
I recommend.
I would argue. Do you have navigate bureaucracy?
Heck no, I don't.
Okay.
I should.
Sounds good.
Did you do something?
So you're going to roll that. Right. I'm going to give you two advantage dice on this.
Okay. Ooh. Great, great. Love it.
Because you have hit a button.
Okay. All right. Oh. Well, I got it, but
got
no
it.
Advantages.
Okay. So first of all, the number matters.
Okay. 22.
22. Okay. Great.
It's a great number.
It's a really good number.
Is that a good number?
Relative
really good
to
number.
Any target number in this game, it's an awesome number.
All right. So you flag her down. Okay. And you bring her down to your cell, and she approaches your cell, and you know she's probably shorter than you are actually, although she's more athletically built. She kind of looks up at you, and she says. You know, she says to you, like, you know, what's your business and what you're trying to get her attention. You do the whole spiel about, you know, I can get you a promotion. She narrows her eyes. You've definitely drawn her interest, but she's very suspicious. I mean, you are in a jail cell right now, but your outfit speaks of wealth and influence, etc.
I'm here because I want to be.
So basically you've caught her attention, but you haven't fully convinced her yet. So the way this works is that, like you guys, certain important judge control characters have luck. She has luck, just like you guys do, and when you do things to try and convince her to do things for you, you're depleting her luck. You're basically reducing it by the amount equal to the number that you rolled.
Okay.
So you reduce it by 22.
Reserve.
I see.
Exactly,
okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So once her luck reaches zero, you get what you want out of her.
Got it.
So at this point, you've got her attention, but not fully.
Okay.
So now that's you. So the three of you have come up through the hole in the floor. What's going on?
Do I stink a little more now that I've come up through the porta johns?
God, yes.
You can?
I can smell you from here.
I request that you go to the Jakes to soap yourself.
Tidy up.
Please clean yourself. Seriously, you are the worst.
You are going to blow our cover.
We'll spend around. I don't care. Just
you smell like poop and death.
Poop death.
Pee-pee time.
All right.
Okay.
So glad this is going to be the meme that comes out of this live stream, by the way.
Peepee time.
Hashtag
peepee
time. All right,
no. All right, so. I guess it seems to me that happened.
Liz, this is on the internet. Come on.
I know.
Oh, it's
forever.
On the internet forever now.
All right, so during drama scene, now each of you is going to get a turn. She took hers to distract Emily Carver. There are still guards to deal with. They are all back in the cell block area, so you actually have a free pass through the front area.
Okay.
So each of you can get to a turn, then it'll go back to me.
Okay, I want to. So I think that we're coming up around here, going through the break room.
Mm-hmm.
You wash yourself.
I am going to pick up a bar of soap to wash myself because there's only a certain smell that I only permit must to come off of me. Anything else? I'm not keen
so
on.
So we're into your must.
Yes.
Got it.
So much of his authority is based.
It's weird that soap doesn't sell well to others. So you're trying to really make that a
must
business.
You know, I'm thinking about making it into a business, but
it's
very niche.
It's very niche.
Anyhow.
But what does Sebastian do?
Yeah, what do you guys do?
I would like to see what's in the break room. Are there anything worth noting in the break room?
It's basically where they take their ease, they play cards, there's some food, like jerky and, you know, salted pork and stuff like that there, but
that sounds delicious.
It's nothing exceptional.
I
just
also
where they
don't mind salty
dogs?
Pork.
There are no guard dogs.
Okay. Should we set one of the watch officers' desks on fire?
Well, that's a little, that escalated quickly. Holy shit.
I'm asking. I didn't do
I
it. Do we all just like
yeah, can
straight
I, can
creep
I
in?
Creep up to where I can see into
if,
the
if we're,
officer's
if
desk
If we're in this
area?
Building, let's walk authoritatively towards where we're going.
Any day now, folks.
Yeah, right. So, yeah, you basically can come all, you get all the way around the corner to where you can see down to the guard post.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so, yeah.
Without
see...
being noticed by anybody or anything.
Yeah, because we're being sneaky until we get here, like, amateurs. Until there are guards. So where are the guards on the map here?
Where do we see
They're
guards?
In the guard post area.
Oh, okay.
Okay. All right, how many?
There are three of them.
Okay.
So now can I throw in one of my noxious
poisons?
Oh, fine.
Okay, so yeah, we should have defined it more clearly, but basically you're doing an inhaled poison that has what negative or that has
it,
what effect?
It just lays them out cold.
Knocks
like,
them out?
It
okay.
just knocks them out. It doesn't kill them,
okay.
but it definitely...
Well, I mean, right. unless they
and
have
I believe,
certain pulmonary
poison,
or respiratory
it also
problems,
says that
you never
one dangerous
his
aspect
smell
of its
probably
use.
Already knocked him out cold.
What is the dangerous
still
aspect
hasn't
of using
used
it?
His heat.
You mean like,
shade thrown, everyone.
Like a
shade
side
thrown.
Effect almost, or...
Something dangerous about using this thing.
He uses all of his heat, and there is an army right there.
I am very worried about the heat.
I know.
Dangerous to you, I mean.
Oh, it's dangerous to me.
I don't,
okay.
I don't
okay.
know what the current economy is relative to what
it's
heat.
It's true. Such a tight fit into this vial that the glass shatters and can actually come and explodes in the area and can cut you upon shattering.
Okay.
The gas pours out so quickly that it just shatters all the glass. All
right, so
I'm gonna hide behind the corner when you
danger of like glass shrapnel,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah.
Right, so you're tossing this in.
Yeah.
Okay, great. So why don't you go ahead and give me a roll? If you have a roll to throw something, you can use that.
I don't use an alchemical object.
This is not. It's not. It kind of behaves
it
like
is.
An alchemical object, so I'm gonna call that a yes.
You
yeah.
argue.
It
all
is.
Right, so go ahead. Thanks.
I've never played percentage. This game before, but it is.
Let me tell you.
All right.
I did not pass
oh,
that.
Jesus Christ.
Roll
oh, 87.
Okay, so here's what you can
first
do. Oh, no,
one.
This is an attack, so you can't push your luck. All right.
Oh, come on.
No.
I'm not attacking. I'm throwing this into a crowded area.
I got it. So you've got this, tightly
it's an
packed
aggressive
bottle.
Throw yeah. with ill intent. It's not an attack.
Yeah.
You got this tightly packed bottle.
Yeah.
And you lean around the corner and you toss it around and you sort of brace yourself because you don't want to get hit by the glass debris.
Right.
And you just hear tingle, 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 tingle as it rolls around the corner and doesn't
no.
break.
All right, I run out.
God damn it.
I run out
draw
and take him down.
So did they like see the bottle like ding, 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 yeah. ding,
yes.
ding, ding, ding.
All right, so so that means that Fast Betty, Fast Betty Twerkin going to do her thing.
Twerkin time.
All right, so.
I yell, meet my associate, Miss Twerkin.
So you're... All right, so you're going to leap out and attack.
Yodel, bitch. Here we go.
Wait, technically, I feel like she should get an advantage because my throwing and
distraction. Yes.
Well, they're all looking that
what
way.
What he said.
You have.
I'm going
like,
to use a hand
thing?
Crossbow.
You have a crossbow?
I have a crossbow.
Oh, you do.
Is that a skill?
Okay. When the yes, I have a
oh,
crossbow.
Yes, you guys.
When you check a target with physical attack, you decide that neither or nor...
You can neither you nor your target make any noise.
Okay, thank you. May no read good.
But I believe welcome. The carve your way out is the important one here.
Carve your way out.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Two advantage dice on minions. Do these guards?
These guys
aren't
minions. Yes.
Two advantage dice.
Okay, right. So I'm gonna stabby stab.
Okay.
With your crossbow.
Crossbow and then two knives.
Okay,
okay.
Sounds
okay.
great. All right,
those
so go ahead and give me the roll for it.
Stab someone. Oh, wait, didn't you give me a...
I gave you all sorts of cool stuff for
stabbing.
Oh,
he did give you two
more?
Dice, yeah.
Two more
we
advantage
don't even
dice.
Have enough advantage dice for this fucking
yeah,
super.
Yeah, you have
bitch,
a cap of four.
That good.
A four? Okay. Well, I only have
she
three.
Has three.
There should be
there was only three
wow.
out there.
No, it's under Lane's hand. Lane was literally hiding it.
Lane
was literally...
oh, oh it's
it.
A win.
I got it. There.
Was no. it good? Because I'll keep it.
Actually, call it now. Call it now. Keep it. Keep it. The winds of chance. Keep it. Keep it.
Keep it.
Yeah!
Yes! That's what a mastermind does.
All right. Great
so
roll.
I got two boons and 23, which is very good. Obviously with it.
All right. So
I'm not good. Yeah.
So you ended up with a 23, so success, and two boons. All right. So the way it works is when you attack a group of minions, every boon you roll is going to take out one additional one. So these guys can only take one hit anyways. So you're basically going to take out all three of these guards.
Overdid it.
Why don't you go ahead and tell me what it looks like when you go in here and take these three out.
Thank you. All right, so I do like a leapfrog. First of all,
A leapfrog.
No.
I get down on the ground.
I shoot the first guy with my hand crossbow, okay. And as he's falling, I jump over his shoulders, leapfrog style.
Wow,
nice. And then just knife the next two,
nice.
And then I do a whoa. All
right,
nice. I'm really glad I didn't see
you
any of that.
Twerking
that sound?
Time.
You
I would have rolled my
sound.
Eyes at you. But I can't see any of it.
Okay.
I don't make a sound because it's silent.
That leaves Rodman Rothman. You still get to act, and the lieutenant, who has been distracted, you can hear her around the corner give a cry of surprise.
Okay,
as you
see
your assassin companion leave.
I'm actually
in.
Going to just march. So as she does that, as she's completing it, flourish and all, I'm just going to march past and step over people and into sight of the lieutenant, who is talking to my accomplice, Pomplemousse, here, and say, well, surely you can see that the situation is well in hand vis-a-vis our action, so why don't you just deal with us?
So it sounds like you're trying to intimidate
like
her.
Do you
actually,
like,
I'm trying to convince
do your
someone.
Captain's hat?
Okay, yeah, you're trying to convince her.
This is not hostile. I'm actually, yep. I'm addressing her as an, as
are you talking
a,
to Emily Carver?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. All right, so you're basically trying to convince her to surrender and not put up any resistance.
I am,
well,
and
take
the,
her
the,
deal.
The tone is, I'm not threatening you because this is so far past where you have authority.
As you can see.
Do you point at your captain's hat and like, look, I'm a captain.
Yeah.
You're a captain.
Exactly. Let's have a captain talk.
captain.
All right. Mono amon.
17.
I was like, yep. I had this.
I have 80%
I didn't need
for that.
Your help, Rodman.
Fucking
I almost
Rodman.
Fucking
I, they gave me a turn.
All right. So
I had to do something.
So you come around the corner, and you're like, obviously, you know what's going on here. And you basically give her the spiel. There's sort of this long pause where she blinks, and she doesn't say anything, and nobody else says anything. You're all just kind of like, and she draws her saber, and she says that there's more fight in me than you think. And she actually basically takes off running. She doesn't run towards you where
thank
you're
God,
coming in.
I have a
she
fighter.
Runs.
Wait, where did she go?
She runs
she's
around
here.
The opposite way.
She's going this way.
Yes.
Right,
she's
going to the gong tower.
The
gong. Oh, no, she's going to the gong tower.
Like
gong?
Really
good. Can
oh,
I load
bullshit.
my hand crossbow?
Yes.
And
shoot
walk
her in the
way?
Ass.
Okay.
Did I miss while
boom.
I was peeing the fact that there's a gong tower?
I have a vial
tower?
Of
no,
of
I didn't actually read
stuff. Can I throw
either.
It at her?
Hang on, we'll get to all that because it's about to be your guys' turn again.
Did you guys know there was
the
a gong tower?
So she's
maybe
running.
Maybe it's not
I'm a much better
like.
Throw
yeah.
than Bastion over here.
Than the guy that makes
it's
it.
It's an hour.
I just make it. I don't implement it.
Yes. That's just where they watch the gong show. It's fun.
Guys, I think there's a gong in there.
Yeah, ye old gong
it's
show.
Gonna be really bad. Oh, no, he's using the heat.
All right,
oh, what
so.
The shit?
Bring the heat.
No, don't tell him.
I mean, don't bring the heat.
Ignore the heat.
Because we are in the final scene
coming
of the job,
hey,
I can
what?
Spend heat to introduce a complication. Normally, I can only introduce complications either at the start of a scene or if you guys have a failure, I can introduce a scene. And it's the judge's turn. I spend 12 heat. To
order.
Introduce a complication. She runs around the corner, and all of a sudden, you guys hear,
boom!
No!
As she runs around to the gong tower, and she's rung the gong once, and
really
you hear from high overhead, this gong is echoed.
And then hordes follow.
Hey, no worries. I already quarantined this whole goddamn district.
Yeah, she quarantined the district.
She has basically sounded an alarm.
I should have said that after we heard what you did.
She's basically sounded an alarm that is echoing out through the entire district.
I yell, Emily, it didn't have to be like this.
Great job, Pompilus, with your whole
your
thing.
Your promotion's taken back, Emily.
All right, so you kill the three guys in the basically the guard post, so you can kind of see where she ran around in
oh,
the guard
yeah.
area.
I would
she's
like
right
that
there.
I
you basically
I
saw her coming from the other side.
And I saw her running that way. So I shoot her with
well,
a hand cross
one second.
Bow before she rings the gong.
No, she rings the gong.
No!
And then you see she turns and looks like she is about to charge towards you.
Can't you kind that of, gong.
You, like, you think say. She's about to charge right at you, right? And then you realize that her eyes are locked not on you, but on something just kind of to your left. And you look over and you see that strapped to the wall is what looks like a clay pot, right? Strapped to the wall. And there's a hammer dangling on a chain next to
it. In case of emergency.
Break pot?
Exactly.
Oh, no.
That's what it looks like.
I bet it's full of ninja smoke.
All right, so that's her
or
turn.
Snakes, one of the two.
Back to you guys.
Okay, I want to shoot her. I have reloaded my hand crossbow in the time that it took her to run around.
Okay, take a shot.
Okay, so I just rolled it. Whoop, I roll this.
Yes.
She's not a minion, I guess.
She's not a minion.
What is the effect on the gong considering that the district has been quarantined?
You don't know yet.
Okay, so it's shoot someone, right? Because it's
yes,
shooting.
That's correct.
Okay, so 75, which is under 80, which was the limit. So, and I do 30 damage according to this.
Oh, you do plus 30.
Plus
so
30.
What? Is the number you rolled plus 30.
Jesus.
No.
105.
Okay. Oh. All right.
Did we kill Emily? Is Emily dead?
Oh my God.
Make her make a noise.
Rod, man.
Did she get impaled? Did she get impaled on the gong?
So great. Tell me what happens when you kill her.
Oh, she dies.
Oh, she's dead.
Yes.
Well, wow. So she's running towards.
I'm
the
not gonna lie to you. I thought we were going a different way with Emily.
And
I really anticipated.
And then she lands on the gong. And I'm
okay.
And I say,
isn't the gong up in the tower?
So you ring the gong again with her dead body?
It's worth it,
idiot. God.
For whom the bell tolls.
Whoa.
It's you!
And then, piggybacking on your other catchphrase, you say, gong, bitch.
Gong, bitch.
Oh, that was better. Damn it.
Oh, yeah, that.
Gong, bitch.
All right. That's terrible.
I'm sorry. That's what I said. Okay. True.
So, you take Carver out. She drops.
I thought we were.
I stare at you in horror.
So that
did
I thought
obviously.
I was walking around the corner and she's
so
like, God,
that
well,
leaves,
shit.
That leaves God. The three of you. Alvinius is locked in the.
I unlock him. We're out.
Okay. Well, so you'll use your turn to unlock the.
Yeah.
Okay. So you do that.
Yeah.
So you two are out.
Yeah.
So what do you two do?
High five each other? Because, you know.
The gong is
see what's in the pot. See what's in the pot?
So can one of you guys look out a window and see if anybody's
actually responding
to the gong?
So the because
you did quarantine the district.
I did quarantine the district.
So this all happened around the guard.
Quick planning.
So on the sorry, Mr. Judge.
Oh, actually, I'm
listening.
Where on this map is the window here? Windows, and where on this map is the clay pot?
So the gray walls that you see there,
yeah.
Those are double thick, so they don't have windows.
Okay.
Otherwise, there are pretty much windows everywhere. The clay pot is basically right there.
Okay.
Let's not worry about the clay pot.
Yeah, I'm going to stay the fuck away from that pot.
Yeah.
I am going
about
to.
That pot, so I'll
we,
do it
we
my
came
next
up
turn.
From below, and we sort of rushed in here. I'm going to make sure that both doors that we know are in this building are blocked and barred. Because we'd want to exit and people are coming here.
Okay.
We're going to go out through the underground.
That's great.
What a great idea.
Why don't
I don't like how happy he is right now.
All right, so you're going to run up to the front door and bar
son
it.
Of a
is that correct?
Oh, boy. The bounty
hunters.
Is that
I'm running to the front door and making sure that it's
you guys,
barred.
The bounty hunters are going to be there.
Do you have, let's say, break something?
Oh, boy.
Or another skill that you think would be good for this?
Nope.
All right, great. Roll anything else.
You got this.
Roll for push junk in the way.
Oh, what is happening?
Hold on, I'm thinking about it.
Okay. Are you
while he's doing that,
he's gonna. Okay, oh, yeah. We'll go ahead and do yours.
I'm thinking about what I did before.
Can
now
I
to make
check
this better?
Can I see if I like look out the window to see where the bodyguard or the bounty hunters are? Is there a way for me to look and try?
Yeah,
to find
you'd
them?
Be going to the front basically, right? There are barred windows.
Okay.
So you'd be going to the front with him basically.
Okay. I will go to the front with
wonderful.
Him. But am I able to? Can I see?
Yeah, you can see out onto the street. They're kind of like high up, like at eye level, but they're barred. You see rushing across the street are these two bounty hunters. They look like they are making haste directly towards you. Additionally, you can see that the armored coach that was here to take Grimes off has arrived and has spilled out a contingent of city watch officers that are rushing towards the door as well.
Okay, bar the door and then we just.
Unfortunately,
go
my influence
room.
Was ill spent.
Where is
yeah,
the
great job, Sebastian?
Wait,
he needs those city watches there. I mean, who knows?
Where is the?
I'll give you the explanation when we get to the end.
I know
you actually, you know, your thing actually did do something.
Yeah, it's great.
Front door is that one, I believe.
All right, so you're running to the front. You look out. I mean, looking out, that doesn't take a power action.
That's the front door up there.
Okay, so the front
door. God, is there a way I can distract them somehow?
There's absolutely no way you can distract them except with your terrible
I actually
smell.
Feel like he says foolishly,
I waft
the door.
My, Wait, what?
I actually feel like, asterisk, he says foolishly, like I have the door.
How?
I got the con.
Because I can, good lord. I'm trying to remember
how to. Yeah, you don't know.
This. Yeah, no, I can use this to have a flashback to a thing I did to plan for a contingency before we started.
You put a bomb on the door.
I love that you have a
retcon ability. You put a bomb
on
the door.
No, I have a built-in retcon.
All right, so what do you do?
Does the door open in or out?
Inward.
Inward?
Yeah.
Oh, this is easy then.
How did you know to put a pit trap in right there?
No. So I have a breaker bar, which is always useful in break-ins, which is a big fucking iron bar.
Right. Yep.
And I've got a bag with spikes and a mallet in it. And I'm running back, and I throw the breaker bar through the handles in the front of the door, and I'm putting four spikes in the ground. And that's at least going to slow people on the way into the building, and we're getting the fuck out of here.
All right. So I'm still going to get you to roll to bar
the
door.
Influence.
However,
the
yeah, you're using the crew influence to do that. However, I'm also going to give you, for the advanced prep, we're going to give you two advantage dice.
Thank you.
To go along with that.
Nice.
Nice.
Okay, what is your...
What roll do you want me to make?
It'll be anything else.
Crew, I want to remind you, we all still have a crew.
Oh,
shut up.
Wait, 50%.
It's dead 50.
What does
that
mean?
Perfect. That's a success.
Yay! Woo!
Wow.
Let's try
it. Any boons?
One boon. Oh.
That was amazing.
For a guy that usually has his best ideas after the fact, this class is perfect for me.
Yeah. That is a good class for you.
2020.
Right. So you start jamming these things at the door. You're barring the door. And then all of a sudden, you feel like weight slam into the door. You barely sort of hold it closed. And you realize that the two bounty hunters have approached. But it held. And you hear from outside a woman's voice say, she shouts out to the guard. She says, quickly, go around to the back. They're going to try and get out that way. This one's barred.
Oh.
Break room.
They think they're going to go to the break room, but we're not.
You're also kind of looking out the
Where
window.
Where is the underground
You
so
see
right
that
the
right
we're
so we are going
to
be
she
we're
gonna
go there.
Says
we're not
to the other bounty hunter, is the short, squat bounty hunter that's talking. She says to the other bounty hunter that she is going to go get the horses. Ooh. So she takes off to go get the horses.
I love horses.
Yeah.
I know you do. All right, so that was your turn.
This is the team influence.
Yes, the team influence that was just spent. All right, so you are looking at the front, and now you can see that the only bounty hunter that's left is
the
sort of tall, slender one.
And a mallet.
Okay.
Yeah, that is looking out.
I am going to... Which way is she looking?
She ran off, basically.
Oh, so there's nothing out front.
No, right. Sorry. Out front is the tall, slender bounty hunter, the tall guy.
So the lady
but
ran
looking
this way.
Where is that one looking in?
He's like shoving on the door.
If she's smart, she'll run this way.
Is there a way I could get out? There's bars on the windows, right? Shit. I am going to pull out Sebastian's monofilament alchemical whip.
What?
Sebastian!
Yeah. He's trying to bring back this thing from when we playtested previously.
And
is that part of your equipment?
Yes.
No.
Is now.
Ish? No.
No.
Okay.
He's making things up.
Well,
that's okay. What do you got?
What else you got?
Isn't all role-playing just making things up,
though?
True.
He
does have
there.
Conceal an object, yeah. 90%. He could have had that whip the whole time.
Are we able... I am concealing...
Rodman, allow it.
Concealing a giant...
Okay, so anyways... I am going to try and distract that person looking in.
Okay. How?
Or the one bounty hunter that's
trying
to shove on the door.
Crossbows.
Yeah.
Two?
Two crossbows. I wrote it down.
How can I distract him?
You can't.
You can.
Go get it.
Okay.
What?
It's around the corner.
Go ahead and just tell me how you do it.
if your turn comes up,
I'm trying to think.
If your turn comes up and you're not here, I'll just have you stab some.
Because I don't have any poison or any vials
it might
left.
Be
so I'm going to put on my mask,
okay.
My gravedigger mask with
okay.
the long nose.
Right.
I'm so excited.
Yeah, I know. This is great.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just going to charge out and
first room up there.
Squawk and try and stab him.
Squawking?
Okay, so you're going to push through. Goddamn, like, he's barred the door. You're going to push through that.
Yeah, I'm going to do, like, I'm going to take the bar and do, like, almost like a somersault. Like, I'm going to jump around
I
the bar.
I don't
like,
even know.
What are you
I
doing?
I'm gonna
he's basically taking down where you've barred the door.
I spent an influence for that.
But it did something.
That's keeping people out right now.
He just
our means of
ingress
are halved.
So you've got your plague doctor mask,
yeah.
And you did quarantine the area.
Yeah.
You could basically like stick your head up and try and convince him that this is where the plague is.
Oh, don't come here. Disease here.
Yes.
Oh, don't want to come in here, friend.
Bring out your dad.
Hey.
All right.
That's nice.
I got 29 on my distract.
Oh, how's
nice.
It going, bounty
very
hunting?
Good.
Don't want to come in here. I got plenty of disease in
no,
here.
No, just suddenly
hey,
the plague
come on,
guy. Out in all here. Right.
You see he recoils and staggers back from the door, and he says, plague. No, that can't be. And he like covers up his mouth. You think that he is terrified of getting sick. And he staggers back
nice.
Away from the
wow.
door.
Germaphobe. Nice.
Happens.
You know. Sebastian.
All right. So.
Gotta get me one of
huge.
Those.
They are going to run around to the back door. All right. You guys hear sounds of the city watch starting to make their way in the back door.
Son of a
front door.
And this guy.
I don't care for
he,
it.
So the bounty hunter, the bounty hunter that you stuck your head up and talked to, he is staggering back with his mouth covered, and he shouts to you, "Why did you ring the gong? If there's a plague in there, man, you'll bring the whole district down on you." You think that he is actually like, you know, while he is terrified, he also it, like looks like he might be running to like get ready to go get like other people to help. But he's not going to. Like he's just like you know, recoiling, trying to figure out what to do. He's on the verge of panic, but you
he
know.
Just says,
yeah, you don't think that he is
he's useless
likely
right
going to be able to, you know, get help in time to
sure,
affect
sure,
you guys,
sure.
right? All right, so the watch officers came in the back door, and now it's back over to you guys.
They're okay. So they're in here. How many?
You. Well, actually, Rodman and Sebastian can see them now,
okay.
Sort of coming around the corner. You can see that there are a half dozen officers, and there seems to be a lieutenant with them as well.
How?
So there's seven people total.
Where is Pamplemousse?
In the
one,
cell
right?
block, yeah.
Wait,
I
she hasn't
left.
She hasn't left.
No, you use your turn to open the door.
Done.
We have a clay pot on a wall.
So is it
you
just
have a clay pot
it's
on the wall.
Too,
I want to break the clay pot.
Pamplemousse and Alvinius,
yep.
And anybody else in the cell block besides me?
Still back in the cell block is
Fast Betty.
Fast Betty, thank you.
Fast Betty is gonna break that clay pot.
All right, y'all need to figure out this break room situation while we make our way to you.
So you're not there yet?
Nope, neither of us are. We're in the jail cells.
Oh,
can
you
throw down some spikes or something around the corner, or is that gonna take too long?
Well, my plan was to run back and try and spike the back door with the leftover spikes and a mallet.
No time.
Now I'm just gonna spike people. That's not true. I'm terrible at fighting.
I have two knives.
Well, you also you still have the vial,
nailed
right?
It.
So you could still knock them out.
Correct, but I have to get there.
Yeah.
And I have a very long dress and very high heels.
Okay, I know what I'm going to do.
Well,
so
okay.
Classic action
you're
movie scene. You just need to shorten that hem.
All right, let's go ahead and go with
Fast
Betty.
Betty.
Miss Torgan,
if
you're nasty.
Nasty.
Oh!
Nice.
All right.
So I'm going to break the clay pot.
You're going to break what?
You're
going
to break the clay pot.
Oh, why do you say it like that?
I'm just asking questions.
Why the fuck would you break the clay pot?
Because I think there's something inside of it that I want.
Okay,
like
so
diamonds?
You go,
what do you think
you go get
said?
The mallet and you smash the clay pot?
Oh, the way that your face said that, now
I'm
it's
just,
like
I'm just asking.
It's definitely some
you already
gas.
Said that you're, yeah.
All right, I'm doing it.
Okay, good. Perfect. All right, so you smash the clay pot, and when it happens, there is like a thick, viscous liquid inside that, you know, the clay pot smashes. It drops down to the ground, and where it spatters on the tiled floor, you can see that it begins an alchemical reaction. And the very quickly, blue sparks spray up from the tiles there and then begin to coruscate across the floor. So you and you are each going to take 30 damage as the alchemical lightning stones.
It could have been something cool.
As the alchemical lightning stones electrocute you.
I didn't say
he has a glee on his face. To be fair, what I actually I thought was a thing to do was
something?
To grab it and throw it at the guards. That's
if the guard, if the captain of the guard was going for it, how could it have possibly?
All right, so that was Fast Betty's turn.
I'm leaving her here.
Yeah, that's that's fair.
That was your choice. You made it.
Oh, choices
my God.
Have choices. Repercussions.
Can I carry? Can I put Alvinius on my shoulders, and or can I ride on Alvinius?
He's definitely bigger than you.
Okay, okay. I'm gonna ride him.
Whoa! All right. What?
Wow. Yep.
Like piggybacks.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. So I have a long dress, high heels. He can
sure.
be faster. Right.
You ask him to carry you, is what you're saying.
No. I don't ask.
You command him to carry you.
I command him to carry
you. All
right. Thank
you
very
much. Sure, no problem.
Yeah. You said, prisoner, bear me about the room.
And he takes a look at Fast Betty. And he's
like,
kill you
with a smile.
He's like,
what about her? What about her? And I'm like, fuck her. She's an idiot. Let's get the hell out of here. So we're going to go around, I guess, the all-chemical nightmare.
It's basically the entire cell block got a jolt of electricity, and it looks like the reaction is keying up to do it again.
Okay. Oh, good. Okay, yeah, so we're going to run to the double-walled gong tower and take shelter until it passes, I guess.
Okay.
Is it safe there?
You can see that the tiles that are electrocuting extend into the cell block from the guard post, uh-huh. but do not go out into the main hallway that goes in front of the captain's office.
Okay, and they're electrocuting like every few seconds? Or
yeah. Like, it looks like that whatever
that's... Is the thing we're familiar with?
Is none of you guys have ever been in jail before, maybe? Or
sure,
I've played like Diablo. I've seen Galaxy Quest. I know how to like.
It's basically like electrified floors.
I can time the thing. Yeah.
It's not a chemical reaction that is. This
no,
day.
It's a classic time damage thing with the interval. Yeah, I got this.
All right, so you can run
off. Yes.
Who wrote this episode?
What?
All right,
so
you can run out.
I'm going to hang out here and then wait for my opportunity.
Yeah,
to run
we can just say that you time it correctly to run out.
On the GPS?
Okay, so I'm running out this way.
Okay.
On being carried by Alvinius, my mount. Okay.
Sure, right.
Wonderful.
We call him a horse.
So that's just really moving around. That's not really an action.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
So we're going to run to the break room where what exactly is happening?
That is where 6 city watch officers and a lieutenant have broken in the back door.
And these two are
the
where?
I think the best idea is go through
people.
The front door.
I'm excited too.
The front door appears to be impenetrable.
Your exit to the old city is in the Jakes over there.
Yeah, we got to get to the Jakes
that's
to
another
get
word for
underground.
Bathroom.
So they say. I've heard this.
Anyhow.
Okay.
Oh, wait, still got the
I do have the puff, so I think probably what I'm going to do is, while still mounted on Alvinius,
derogatory way to refer to
I'm going to try to intoxicate the entire break room with my gas bomb.
Okay. Okay, yeah, the one that he created.
The one that he created.
The reverse smelling salts.
God fucking help me with Sebastian's craft.
Oh, do we still have that?
Yeah.
Yeah,
she still has it,
but
she never used it.
Yeah, I never used it.
All right. I didn't know that was in play.
So I'm going to give you, or let you make that roll. It's use an alchemical object, or also
nope.
It could just be throw something if you have that.
Okay. Got nothing.
Anything else?
I say it's like a pick a lock.
So it's anything else? It's definitely not picking a lock.
I got nothing.
Is it like appraising something?
It certainly is not.
It's a 50%. Come on, folks.
Also, give yourself an advantage down this.
Oh, thank
because
goodness.
Basically, like you're throwing a gas into a large group of people.
Yes!
40.
Oh, 40.
That's how did we get to the final countdown?
All right, so you hurl this into the area, and it basically lands at one guy's feet and bursts upward at him, and he just wipes out back.
Right.
The other ones sort of recoil and cover themselves. So you took one out, but the other ones are still up.
Okay.
All right, so that was her, and so now the two of you still haven't acted this time.
Come on, Sebastian. Pull something out of your fucking smelly butt.
I have a question. Okay. Am I able to, like, scoop up some of this blue stuff?
It's not smelly. It's
in,
musty.
Like, black...
You've already done your fucking turn.
Mustay.
I'm just curious. All right. For future.
How about it here, guys?
So...
I've done enough.
This might have been something to bring up earlier before we came here and assaulted a jail.
Good. All right.
I'm terrible at fighting people.
Yeah.
So I point forward and look at you.
Wait, did the thing
so
go
you,
off?
You guys did mention run like hell. Happened? You could always just try and run right past them to the old city. This doesn't have to be a fight. It could be a chase.
Well, I don't need to belabor that. That's what I want to do.
Okay. So you're going to dash past them.
I yell, "We're out."
Okay, and try, and you're going to try and dash past them straight to the Jakes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
Jake dash.
Teamwork.
Give me a roll to run like hell. I'm going to give you one I'm going to give you one challenge die on that.
60.
As you run.
Barely made it. Yeah.
Nothing.
Got it. 65% to run like hell.
Perfect.
Yeah. You did it.
All right, so you dash past them, and you actually, like, as you're running by the guards, you kind of shoulder one of the guards into the wall, and he kind of slams up against the wall and slides down.
Nice.
And his head...
What about you?
So
as I run past them, I'd like to distract one of the guards
and
just smack him in the face.
Slap him?
Yeah, just
slap him. You want to grab his butt?
Just yell. When you do that, just yell, "You know why."
Is that a distract someone?
Yeah, that's
a
distract someone.
You know why.
You know why.
You know you did.
You did this.
All right, so yeah, you basically like run up and like
boof,
slap him across the face. All right.
All right. Done.
Fucking 33.
Yeah, lovely.
Nice.
That
was hard.
All right, this guard staggers backward, completely stunned by this.
By a fucking plague doctor. By a plague doctor just smacking me in the face.
Wash
like.
Your hands!
All right. So, the guards
do you want ants?
The guards
not the right time to practice cleanliness.
Did you floss?
I'm so sorry, Rodman.
I know, it's fine. the guards... do not react well to you slapping one of their number. They immediately try and fall upon you, and you can see they have manacles, and they're trying to arrest you with manacles.
Good. You're the scapegoat. It's fine.
Somebody do it.
Luckily, you are able to slip out of their grasp.
Yay!
And the watch lieutenant, he steps up, and he's got a saber drawn. He's going to take a swipe at you with his saber.
Uh-oh.
Fortunately, you managed to get past, so you're out of the way. That is a success.
You didn't have to
that's
going to
be 40 damage.
Damn.
Ooh, this is going to go well.
That's 60. Slapper. Ooh, you're weak.
I'm going to raise no slapper.
All right, so it's back over to you guys.
Okay.
So you've run basically over to the entrance into the old city. Do you want to drop in without these guys and start making your escape?
I'm helping.
Yes.
I'm the one who helped you.
Wow.
Yes, I would.
Well, no. Here's the genuine. I actually think we're running.
Yeah.
This is just me justifying my cowardice.
Yeah, everybody get the hell out.
I think we're running, and I have literally nothing to contribute to a standing fight.
Okay. I have two knives.
Everything I can do now is worse than me running.
And to distract someone. So I think I want to just, like, throw my knives in an attempt to distract two of these guards.
And
while
you're,
riding,
like, hanging on to
while
Alvinius.
While riding Alvinius. Okay. Yeah.
Right. Nice. Go ahead and make your roll. I'm going to give you one challenge knife for this because you're doing it from his back.
From the back of Alvinius.
From man
back.
Yeah.
Okay. We're fine.
Oh, my goodness.
40?
40.
0-4.
No
drawbacks?
Just a 4.
That's a 4.
Oh, my God. That's a 4.
And no drawbacks?
No drawbacks, yeah.
Okay. All right, so you do this, and so you hurl the knife, and you cause them to recoil.
Okay.
And are able to slip by them. So now you and Alvinius have also made your way.
Wait,
me, Alvinius, and...
Did you hurt them?
Did I hurt them with my plus 10 damage knives?
Yeah. It worked.
I have to come by later, so I was just curious.
Yeah.
Where we're at in this.
So
we're in the sewers with you.
Yeah, so the three of you are now in the sewers.
Great.
What are you guys doing?
Oh, I'm running like hell. I'm getting cut. I'm getting stabbed.
All right, so you're also working it?
So you're going to
run
like
okay,
hell?
Go ahead and give me the roll.
I am
you got not a single poison on you, Sebastian, are you?
No, like I gave it to you.
I gave
it to
you. One poison, that's all you have.
I used the other
you're
one.
You're the poisoner. Your poison's your thing.
Listen, I only do one a day.
All right, fine.
You know, sometimes.
Okay, so anyways.
It takes a lot of work to do these things.
I'm just saying.
Everybody who thinks you got tons of poison on
you. Totally run like hell out of there.
Seven, yeah.
Okay, so how many?
Our dice are,
so here's what's
happening. I'm going to say foolishly, doing really well.
Yeah, 4.
Okay. So Fast Betty, here's what's happened.
Betty's gonna be fast.
Your three companions and Alvinius have dashed into the break room area and either shoved out of the way or thrown knives at or slapped guards. But they've managed
like
they've managed
so I was like running, I'm like
Like a true poisoner does.
So they've managed to get past the guards and into the entrance to the old city. There are still guards there. All six of them are still there.
No, we got two.
They're not dead. They're just
sleeping.
Yeah, well, you got past them.
One passed out.
One of them is unconscious. But there's also a lieutenant there as well.
Sabrin.
Okay, I want to run through and...
Sabres suck. I've come to that conclusion.
Faelor's probably watching this.
Is there anybody else?
Sabres are great.
There's supposedly a bounty hunter in the front door.
Sorry, Mike.
Sorry, Faelor. We love Sabres.
Then I have to get further on the city.
Yeah, but you're an assassin. That's true. You probably want to go with Jake's. Forget me. Forget me.
Well, are you guys able to go through the sewers without me?
Sure.
You spent the influence.
That's true. That's just how hard could it be?
I mean, follow the tunnel.
Maybe
turtles down there. I'm okay with that.
You know what? I want to do something different. I'm going to go... Is the door open? Michelangelo? Do I have to do a thing to open the door?
It's stuck right now, but you can pull the...
Yeah, yeah. I'm going to go through the front door.
Okay. So like you're going to yank monster. The you're gonna yank oh. the things oh. out of the door.
What about the front door now?
So what's your plan?
I'm going to go through the front door, and then I'm going to...
Look at you, Lebowski.
...have two knives, so I can at least take out two people. I'm going to go hit the bounty hunter, who I believe is still out front.
Okay.
He has two crossbows.
Yeah, but...
Just saying.
So you're gonna basically go out the front door.
You told me to go...
You're going to go out the front door, and you're going to try and take out the bounty hunter with a knife?
No, with my crossbow.
With your crossbow. Okay, great. Go ahead and make a roll. Just shoot someone.
He technically counts as a minion, right?
He's not a minion.
God damn it. Whoa.
Nice try, though. I like your
moxie. Can I interact verbally with him as a commoner?
No. Not if you're shooting him.
Am I doing anything besides his dice?
Nope.
Okay.
Nice.
60.
Woo.
Yep.
All right.
I shoot someone at 80, so yep. it's
perfect.
A hit shot.
So you bust out the front door, yanking out the places where he's hammered the stakes in.
For 90 damage.
So you see this bounty hunter is sort of covering his mouth, kind of looking around for help. And when you come out, he whirls around in surprise right as you take him out with the crossbow. And he drops to the ground.
Classic move.
Worst day of this
guy. I actually would like to sidebar the damage thing, because I do forget this part, actually, from when we played before.
Yeah.
So the damage is... The number you rolled plus your damage bonus. So higher is better. So that's even a little bit of a push your luck thing. Is that true? So higher is better, but under your threshold. So
higher is better, but under your threshold. Yeah.
Okay.
So I hit him for 90.
Yep.
With
exactly.
Plus 30 damage.
Yep.
Damn.
Okay. So there's still 4 heat in the heat pool. I'm gonna go ahead and spin that right now.
Oh, jeez, Rodman.
Right. You said you wouldn't think he'd spend that.
Yeah. Okay. So Liz, you.
Why are you what?
No.
Why
this is good for you.
Why do you call her by her American name?
Fast Betty. You take out the bounty hunter.
Yes.
You take out the bounty hunter, and if you want, you can flee into the streets and make your getaway.
That's what I want to do.
Great, perfect. You do. So, meanwhile, Sebastian, Pomplamoose, and Rodman, along with Alvinius, you guys are down in the old city.
Yes.
And like I said, it's sort of like sewers, but also like shop fronts, and you've got the lantern
the
that you left down here that's casting a little bit of a glow, but you've dropped down to the old city, and you're beating a hasty retreat, and you hear the sounds of footfalls behind you, and you realize that the guards are in pursuit. They basically are chasing you through these dark tunnels. When I spent that heat, what I did was I basically spent to re-bolster the guards that you had taken out.
How many guards?
So there are...
Many ago.
There are 5... Well, you don't know how many there are.
Jeez.
But
sure.
They're beating feet behind
can
you.
Can I will yell back to them.
So basically, at this point, it's become a chase.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
While being chased, I will yell back to them, "You're on foreign soil now, boys."
Yeah.
Welcome.
Okay.
So this is good.
So you're basically trying to intimidate them into falling back.
You know what? Actually, I'm going to say no, because it was intended as just being flippant.
Okay.
I could invite them to a party that's happening right now.
You've got a lot of cheese and cake.
Exactly.
All right, so your goal now at this point is to lose the pursuit.
Yeah.
So all your attacks that you're going to be making are going to be to effectively lose them in the sewers.
Are there any other paths in the sewers?
Oh, yes. It's okay. Twisting and turning and windy. All
right. I have sneak around.
Okay. So you're basically going to try and stealthily...
I'm still riding on Alvinia.
Oh, yeah. So you basically are like, no, be quiet. Go over here.
Yeah. Okay. Like and are you guys following me?
Yeah.
As I sneak?
So as you're sneaking, I'm going to say that you're going to have an advantage die on this because these sewers are so, or the old sea is so winding and twisty.
Okay. I'm good.
What?
16 and advantage.
Perfect.
Thank you.
All right. So what happens because
of my advantage?
So that basically gives you extra progress on this.
Okay,
so,
great.
Yeah, you hear, like, as you're sneaking around, you hear the sounds of footfalls.
Footfalls.
falling like further behind.
Not
right, you guys all try and say footfalls falling further behind, okay?
Sorry, Rodman.
So you hear the sounds of pursuit falling farther behind. Sebastian or Rodman?
I throw a football at him.
Okay, now how about what you actually do?
Do I see any objects around me as we're running through here that I could potentially throw?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, there's tons of debris down here.
Okay, so
there are small children begging
skulls,
for money.
Human skulls.
I would love to throw a kid at them.
No kids.
No. Okay, fine.
Street urchins.
I'm not cool with that.
Human skulls.
Yeah.
I was thinking this crew.
I want to pick up something that looks pretty putrid in nature.
Yeah.
So they think this is the plague that
okay.
I was talking about
Perfect.
Initially, and I just find it and chuck it at him.
Okay, great.
The plague.
Give me a roll to throw something at him.
That's a 59.
All right.
Use an alchemical object?
Yes. Yep. A 90% chance of hit.
I don't know if that's using alchemical object.
No,
so.
It's not. But I do chuck this item that looks like it's just reeking of plague. In their direction.
Okay, and you go to what now?
Hmm?
What did you roll?
A 59.
And what's your chance of success?
I'm guessing 50 because it's anything else.
Yeah, that's probably going
to
miss.
I'm not trying to hit them. I'm just trying to, like, scare them into thinking there's plague this way.
Yeah, but I think basically you hook this thing and it splooshes.
That would be a distract someone.
Okay.
Oh,
all right.
Here
sure.
we go.
All right, I'll give you that one.
That's an 80.
Sebastian
okay,
coming
great.
Back.
Boom.
All right. So you hurl this thing, and basically this glob of stuff lands right at the feet of a couple of watch officers right as they come into the radius of your illumination.
And they're like, ew.
Yeah, and they stagger out of the way of it.
Yeah.
All right, Rodman.
Oh, man.
I'm sipping, in case anyone wants to know, I am sipping tea at a local cafe.
You're doing great, fast Benny.
You know what? Honestly, I genuinely don't feel like I have a clever thing to add to this situation, and I feel like I'm running. So I'm going to run like hell.
You're just trying to outpace the pursuit.
Yep.
Okay, give me the roll to run like hell.
16.
60? Success? All right. Nice. Okay. There's still footfalls coming behind you, and they haven't quite given up, but you definitely think they've diminished. All right, so... let's see here. You ran the farthest. You're on Alvinius's back.
But very sneaky.
You've been very sneaky, yes. And you guys come across a like wooden bridge, basically. That's like wooden slats over a sludgy water passageway. Mm-hmm. And he's like carrying you across, and the bridge gives in the middle, and he slips and staggers and falls. And he nearly drops you into the sludge, but he like grabs you at the last second. You're actually going to lose 20 luck from that.
Goodness gracious, Alvinius, you klutz.
Don't stay in that wing.
And that is all. All right, so still a little bit of pursuit behind you, but you guys have another chance to escape.
Okay.
What do you do?
We're going to try to keep escaping.
Going to do what?
We're going to keep trying to escape.
Yes, of course. tell me how you try to escape here.
No, we're going to stand here and mutual discussion about the... rigors
if I look
comment?
Behind me, I'm in front of everyone. You said I ran the furthest, right?
Yeah.
I'm in front of everyone. I'm looking at them like, get the fuck. I'm like, we're running. I'm saying run.
So you've basically found a path that you want people to follow you down.
All right, I'm going to run like hell after him.
Wait, okay. Do you have like money you can like throw out?
So
commoners, like,
I want you to roll this with an advantage die for his help.
Thanks. Ooh, run like hell. Oh, no, it's an 84, but I did get an advantage.
Okay. All right, so that you fail to run like hell, though?
I do fail to run like hell, yes.
All right, but you do get a boon.
Run like heck.
All right, so good news. you basically, like, Alvinius has got you, and he's pulled you up off the where you almost fell, gets you over to the solid ground, and you start rushing towards Rodman and get, like, up to where he is. You haven't quite managed to, like, evade all the pursuit, but, you, like, the three of you are now all together. What do you do?
So we're all together in this little...
Yeah, you're rushing up on them.
Yeah. Scheiße. I'm going to try... I've done my...
Yeah.
I've tried to distract them. I actually take off my mask.
Okay.
And chuck my mask back.
Huge mistake.
Okay. Okay.
As it just kind of like...
Something to throw?
Yeah, it's something to throw at them and just kind of...
Take off those nasty fucking robes and throw them at them.
Okay. Wear robes. I have a nice black suit on.
I would say that if you want to keep trying
out of style,
keep trying to distract them. You can go ahead and make the roll for that.
Suited.
35.
All right. Luckily for you, that is the last thing you needed.
Yeah, so, and it like shocks them that this like horrifying mask has been thrown in their
face. So basically, like, you have caught up to them, and you're the whole group of you now are about to make your escape. You rip off the mask and you kind of throw it on the ground behind you and then take off running.
But they see my face,
which is horrifying.
As I do this, which is horrifying. Scars that line up and down my face, and I just give them a wink.
Right.
And then run.
And so, like, you give them the wink, and right as you do, one of your companions just goes and snuffs out the light. So all the light goes down.
Ooh. Oh, nice touch at the
Very
end,
good
Rodman.
Job, Rodman. Love it. Love it.
And you guys escape. So that's it. That is the jailbreak job. You guys succeed in getting away with Alvinius Grimes. With only a little bit worse for the wear. And
I'm sitting there at the location being like, what took you guys?
Where you guys
been? Yeah.
Fast Betty. That's where you got your name.
Whoa,
that's where I got
fast
my name.
Betty.
Fast abandon the team, Betty. Fast break the clay pot, Betty.
Yes.
Idiot. So you're never going to let me forget that, are you? Nope.
So that is Dust City Outlaws. Thanks for playing, guys. This is up on Kickstarter right now. I would really appreciate it if you thought this looked cool and would like to play this game. If you would back it, that would be greatly appreciated because I need everyone's help to pitch in and help me actually make this game a real thing. So thanks so much, you guys, for playing today. It was really awesome.
This was so much fun. I saw the Kickstarter. Ronnie was like, please look at the Kickstarter so you at least know one thing about the game. I was like, fine. So I went and I watched the video, and I was like, this sounds cool. And then playing this was so much cooler than I thought it was going to be. And I thought it was going to be cool. So thanks, Ronnie. This is an amazing game. This is super fun.
I love the fact that once the planning kicks in and you feel like you're actually participating.
Right.
Like 5 minutes in, you feel like you're participating in the heist. Like, oh, actually, no, I know this thing. We're going to do this. And I know this element of the criminal underworld.
I think I took a pretty weird combo, too. Like the high class thief who's super conspicuous, and even
super
with that
cool.
weird combo, it was really fun.
Mm-hmm.
I love this. I'm gonna back your Kickstarter
today. Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah, this particular job that we did was designed to be a shorter one, and you know we played for about
about two and a half
with character creation, right? Yeah. Which
that's
is pretty good.
That's great, though. Yeah. Honestly,
Mostly, like step in
and get something done and feel like you accomplished something.
Right.
Most jobs take somewhere in the like 2 to 4 hour range. Most of them are closer to 4 hours,
mm-hmm.
But then I also have some that span multiple 4 hour sessions as well.
Nice,
so.
Campaigns.
There's also campaign play, as well.
Yeah.
It's not in the print and play, but it is going to be in the final game.
I love how freeform it is. It feels much more like I've always been bad at D&D because there are so many rules. Like the rule book stuff is terrible, but the fact that like these are all my rules,
mm-hmm.
and then everything is just created in the imaginations of everyone around me is kind of like
we're
the ideal.
Our own narrative.
It's the ideal RPG for me.
Cool.
Yeah, it's really good. Thanks, Rodney.
Thanks, Eric. Do you want to sign us off here?
Yeah, we're actually going to be back playing on February 12th, another round of Dust City Outlaws, and that's going to be same time, same channel, 3:00. So we will see you then. Thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye,
guys.
Thank you.